Is it some devil that crawls inside of you?
Welcome back to the Bad Etiquette Podcast. I'm your host, Dallas Bronson, joined here by my good friend, Dane Freese.
Hello.
Hey, how are you? Fucker. Is that thing on? You got an on switch on?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I always forget. Sometimes I give it to like my mentally deficient friends, and it's just off.
Mm.
I'm also joined in your beautiful cockroach lace department with former guest, Daniel Bax, and future potential guest, Garrett. Balls,
yep.
Johnson.
We're all former guests.
Yes, true. I guess you've all been on here, huh? Was episode 8 or something? Hey, Dane. How you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
Dude, I'm really stoked we got to skate today. How's your knee feeling?
My knee is feeling really good.
So what happened to you had a fucking knee surgery, and I couldn't skate with you for like, it felt like a fucking year.
Mm-hmm.
Because anytime we'd meet up to go skate, you'd be like, oh, I just need another bong rip. And I couldn't fucking skate with you.
Yep. The last year has been a lot of bong rips. But, so basically, the whole knee situation. Initially, I was skating a spot with Daniel Bax. This fag sitting next to me. And it's basically like a pyramid.
Yeah.
I wanted to wall ride up, go down the other side. I was going up towards the top. I saw my nose go over it. So I was like, yeah. All right, I'm going to start pushing down. When I pushed down on the board, I kicked it out, flew forward, and my body was starting to spin.
Yeah.
So I guess I just like straightened out my body, and my knee landed on a pole.
Like on a
sideways.
Fucking pole?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's like a big pole there. So.
Jesus. So you just fucking smacked your knee into a pole?
Smacked my knee.
Jesus fucking Christ.
And then that was the initial one. And I knew it was fucked up, so I just kind of, you know, did a little rehab on my own, and then I fucked it up again at the wreck at Matt's funeral. And then I was out of
commission. Oh, that's right. Yeah. So you had already heard it. I forgot you heard it like the weekend of his funeral. Was that Super Bowl weekend?
Yeah.
I remember because you were icing it and shit, and you had this. You had to get crutches, dude. We went to Me and Ed's Pizza and fucking almost got kicked out of there because Dane was screaming at the fucking TV.
Yeah.
How much? How much money did you have on the fucking Pats that year?
Oh, I had no money on the Pats. Fuck the Pats, dude. Tom Brady's a bitch. I fucking hate Tom
you're
Brady.
Not, you're not
Raider
a
Nation, dog. Like, that's for life.
You're not a Bucks fan now?
No. No, fuck the Bucks, dude. Like, the Bucks. Okay, check it out. No, check it out. Fucking. All right, check it out.
I'm listening.
So, the Bucks. I'm going to turn this mic off. I'm getting so heated. John Gruden is the coach right now. Okay, double mic it. John Gruden is the coach now. And he basically left the Raiders, went to the Bucks, and then we met them in the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
John Gruden and the Bucks, and I was a little kid.
It's yeah.
the only time I've ever seen the Raiders in a Super Bowl.
Well.
And they lost, and I was at the Graduate in SLO when that was like a bar, I guess, or some shit.
Yeah.
And, yeah. Long story short, fucking John Gruden's back, and the Raiders are doing pretty good, but we just got blown out by the fucking Falcons, so Dane's not happy, but fucking Raiders. Yeah, fucking bitch.
All right, fair enough.
Raiders.
I can't believe you like the Raiders and the Dodgers and you're white.
Yeah, and the Lakers.
And the Lakers.
I'm like... A full West Coast.
I think that's cultural appropriation. You need to stop.
Yeah, I know.
That's pretty fucking crazy. You're not even close to Mexican. You're more Hawaiian than you are white to me.
I don't know what the fuck I am anymore.
Where were you born?
born in San Luis Obispo.
Okay, that's cool. You're in like a hospital straight up.
Was a it turned into a mental hospital, right?
Fucking as I'm soon as you sure, came right? out, you psycho.
There was a couple hospitals, and one of them turned into like a psych ward or something like that. And I'm pretty sure that was the hospital I was born in. So that might be crazy.
It's not even remotely real. You're playing a video game, you stupid fuck.
You gotta swoop the controller. Bro, I don't want you to know anything about this. And two,
hey, shut up. I'm recording a podcast with your roommate, Dane.
Shut the fuck up.
When did you move to Hawaii? Because there's a long period of time in our friendship where I couldn't like access you socially because you were in fucking Hawaii.
Yeah, so when I was 16, I smoked a little weed.
That'll do it.
And then my mom's like, I'm going to drug test you. And then she called Garrett's mom. We were all freaking out, so we talked to Brittany, and she's like, just drink a gallon of cranberry juice and you'll be fine. And so I drank a gallon of cranberry juice and I wasn't fine.
You had a UTI?
I don't even know how I fucking drank a whole gallon of cranberry juice, but I did. And anyways, that started a thing called drug tests for me every 2 weeks.
Damn.
For every 3 months.
For 3 months?
So what I started to do was, you know, switch it up. I tried some fucking spice like a retard little fucking dipshit kid. And then I was like, that's fucking dumb. So I tried shrooms once, and I was like, holy fuck, this is tight.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to say any names, but somebody in my family hit me up, and they're like, hey, I heard that you did mushrooms.
Oh, my God.
And I was like, yeah, I have. And they're like, well, would you do them with me? And I'm like, yeah, for sure. They're super fun, and you want to do them with somebody who's done it before. So, so I didn't even do mushrooms. Basically, that was in a text message. I came home drunk
from
a party as a little 16-year-old, and I went in my mom's room, and I'm like, good night, Mom. And she's like, good night. And then she came in my room, and she's like, give me your phone. You're drunk. And I'm like, okay.
Damn.
So I give her my phone, and then I wake up in the morning, and she's just bawling, crying, and I'm like,
bawling, crying?
I'm like, what's wrong? And she's just like, I can't fucking believe you. Like, you're going to ruin your life over drugs. And I'm like, whoa. She's like, you want to do mushrooms with blah, blah, blah. And I can't believe you. It's just like my dad. He died from a heroin overdose. Like, you're going down the wrong direction. Okay.
She wasn't just like losing it, being like a stale white mom.
She has some background issues for sure.
Yeah. I mean, I will honestly say how often is someone slipping off a mushroom into the needle, though, for heroin?
Bernice.
What's your mom's name?
It doesn't matter.
That's fine. I like that. It's Bernice.
She's Mama.
That's fine.
That's who she is.
You're right, yeah.
And she's an amazing woman. I love my mom. She has a great heart, but she's very paranoid about drugs.
Well,
she bought a plane ticket, and I'm like, she's like, you can't stay at the house tonight. So I stayed at Don's house, Donnie's dad.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, you're fine, dude. Like, there's no way. And I call my dad, and he's like, there's one ticket I see, and it's for $2,000.
Holy shit.
He's like, you're not going to, like, she won't do that. Like, yeah. She's not that crazy.
I mean,
she was that fucking crazy.
She was that fucking
into
it. I
met my fucking mom at the airport the next morning, and she was crying.
God.
And she's like, I love you. I hope that you forgive me. Here's a note I wrote, my whole life story. And,
wow. Do you still have that note?
Yeah.
That's pretty. Is it here?
Yeah, I didn't read it till I moved back to California, though.
Really? Holy shit. Can I read it?
I mean, sure.
Dude.
Not on here.
Not on here. But,
but yeah.
She was really fingered by the mall Santa. That's great.
My mom's gone through some shit, you know, and that's why she's so fucking broken. And that's understandable, but, you know, to give up on a child when they're in the prime of making bad decisions, it's like, come on, you know? You know, like, you're just going a little too far.
You thought she was giving up on you instead of, like, making, like, a stand against it because she was willing to spend that much money?
You got to look at it from my angle. She's, like, sending me out to my dad who she's talked shit about my whole life because he's, like, this surfer stoner, like, dad, you know? So
it sounds like she just did the coolest thing she could have done.
No, she's just like, fine, you want it that way? Then go. And I'm just like, all right.
Here, here's a $2,000 ticket to paradise.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good luck.
Yeah, and I'm just like, you know what? Like, I love Maui. I love my dad. Like, fucking kick me out. Send me to fucking Hawaii. Like, I know you won't. It wasn't like a thing that happened once. Like, yeah. She threatened that multiple times. And she did it, which is crazy, but... Yeah, I mean, I met a lot of really cool people.
Yeah.
And it definitely, like, changed
who I am. How long did you live there? From age 16 to when?
Till I was... 23.
Wow. Holy shit. Are you kidding me? You just moved 23? Back like 2 years
ago? Yeah, I've been here for 2 years.
Holy fuck.
Going on 2.5, 3 years, I think. Maybe.
So I really didn't see you for that long?
Yeah, well, no, I would come back. Like, yeah, I would come back with my tax return. That was my trip.
Oh,
I would use
the tax return
as a plane ticket.
Wow, so you actually got a tax return? Yeah. My first tax return was cool, and every one since has gotten worse and worse. I don't know if that means I've made more money or I hate
I'm in the same position. It's weird. I don't know why either. But, I mean, when I was 18, I got into some shit with my dad, so I was like, I'm fucking out of here. And
had a break from him, too. That was Garrett leaving the apartment.
Later, Dad. But, yeah, so, I mean... Boo-hoo, sad story, but it fucking made me who I am. You know, you're 18 years old. You got to go fucking pay rent, go get a job.
Oh, and then you start balancing school.
Yeah, I was on my own when I was 18.
I never knew that. What happened? You got a fight with your dad.
My dad, he's an amazing guy, but he has...
you guys saw some things differently?
No, he has alcohol issues that slowly built up over time because that's what alcoholism kind of does.
Yeah. Okay.
But then it was just a kind of a breaking point. He just said some shit. He was gonna break my Xbox in front of my face, and it was like, I own a couple things. Like, you're gonna break that. Like, fuck you. You know.
That's kind of harsh.
It was just. Yeah. It wasn't really.
What did
anything,
you
but,
do for someone to warrant breaking your Xbox?
Do you really want to know the story?
I mean, if you want to tell it, yeah.
I mean,
but
fuck
like,
it. We're already in it. You already opened me up like a book. So.
Yeah. I did that. That's right.
So basically, I'm at home, and fantasy football is in my dad's life for the first time.
Oh shit!
And he is not computer literate.
Let the cat in.
Hold on.
I got it.
And so basically, he's like, every single day I would have to go home and I would have to type in all of his websites and shit. And I'm like,
help him out with it.
Just go on Google.
Sounds better. You know? It sounds like he's got a little more than my dad.
Yeah. Well, no, he doesn't know anything on technology. So
that's what I'm saying. It sounds like he's already ahead of where my dad's at.
Where's your dad? Where is he at? Doesn't even know what a computer is?
I think he still has a flip phone.
Okay.
Genuinely. Like, well, he's still... Fun.
That's where my dad is too, though, but he wants to be a part of the people that know things.
Yeah, see, my dad doesn't, and I think he thinks he knows things, but it's like, I don't know, man. I could share three memes that would break your argument in half. Yeah. I gotta fuck, you know what I mean? Like,
No. My dad is he loves people so much, just like me, so he, like, needs to, like, be a part of something or something. You know? It's like,
so he likes the community aspect to it?
Yeah, he wants to be part of this work fantasy football. Bullshit, doesn't matter. Anyways, he's like, you know, go on Google. And I'm like, just type in Google.
Yeah.
He's like, no, do it for me. You know that I can't fucking figure out a computer.
He wasn't even like willing to learn.
And I'm like,
yeah,
dude, hit the fucking internet tab.
Yeah.
And it will pop up to Google and you just type in what you want. And, you know, it just got into some super shit like that. And he's just like, you won't ever fucking help me out. Blah, blah, blah. So I'm just like, you know what? Fuck this. I'm going to Sonny's house. And he's like, yeah, fuck you. And he'd get in my face and he'd try to, like, square up with me. And I'm like, you want to That's fight crazy. Your fucking son?
That's crazy.
And he's like, what? And I'm just like, fuck you, you know? Like, fuck you, dude. If you Like, I would never fucking do this kind of shit to my son.
It's kind
of,
yeah.
So, anyways, I'm like, fuck you, I'm out of here. Right then, when I was like, you're going to square up with your son?
Yeah.
You drunk fucking piece of shit? So I fucking went to my closet, I grabbed my shit. He comes up, and he breaks the closet door off the hinge on my fucking back. And I just, like, look up, and I go grab my Xbox, and he grabs it out of my hand, and he's going to throw it down. And I grab it out, and I fucking push him against the wall. And
oh, yeah.
It was one of those things. Nah. So I fucking left, and I was just like, you know.
I wish I could say, no more. I can't even imagine something like that. But if you guys know what it's like to have, like, alcoholic family members in your life, that shit is so normal. And, like, that adrenaline of, like, oh, like, things got serious now because you're drunk is such a normal fucking thing.
Yeah. It's an unnecessary normal thing.
It's a weird, you know, do you think because of that you're more comfortable in confrontational situations?
Yeah, I mean, I understand where drunks are at, you know?
Yeah.
Like when you're surrounded by an alcoholic parent, you know, like, when it's going down. Like, you know your parents,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So I know my dad when he gets off work, and I know my dad after he finishes a six-pack of fucking Sierra Nevadas, you know, and they're two different people for sure. And so then sometimes it's a really cool version, you know, and that's
hard
the side
part.
Where that's it's like the, they want to hold on to that, but it's like it turns into a 25-75 where 75% of
the
piece of shit.
The reward system, you know, isn't there anymore. It's chasing a diminishing return.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I get that.
Yeah, man. So
what'd you do in Hawaii
for work?
Yeah.
So the first job I had was Tom Barefoot Tours. My dad hooked me up with that. And I was in high school. And so I would do work release.
Yeah. And was this before you got, like, in that fight with him? He hooked you up with the job?
Yeah, this was when I was, like, 17.
Mm-hmm.
So, or it was senior year, so I was 17 turning 18 or something.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, so I'd go to school till 12 o'clock on Tuesday and Thursday or something and go work for fucking $7.50 an hour, you know. But it was a job where I basically was making a tour website, and then I would go on the tours. So I got to go on all these amazing, sick tours, like, that tourists would
go
on for free.
So you, like, found all – oh, weird. Was it real touristy, though? Did you see, like,
no,
some kind of, like,
out.
Dorky shit?
I was
shit?
With the tourists, but it was sick. You know, I'd go on coffee tours. I'd go on, you know, like, river rafting. I'd go on Road to Hana tours. I'd go on the zip lines. You know, all those things I got to do and take pictures with GoPros and T3Is and shit. So I was like, fuck yeah. But
so
the bad part was I had to make the whole website portion of it, too.
Oh, really? Was that real hard? Was that real, like,
sucked.
Could you just, just sucked? It was just tedious?
It was like writing essays, you know?
Oh, man.
So,
do you think that's where you get, like, this, like, sense of adventure from, is doing those tours and shit? Because
me?
Yeah, like, I feel like you're always ready to, like, go do something more exciting. Like, you're like, oh, I want to go camping, off-roading, I want to surf, I want to do, you know what I mean?
I think when I moved to Hawaii, I realized how much I love the outdoors.
Yeah.
And how much, like,
especially when the outdoors looks like that.
Yeah. And just how much, like,
Dan,
the world sucks. Like, the stupid bullshit sucks.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't have internet for a really long time.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't have Netflix.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I didn't have Hulu. I didn't have Instagram when I was at home. Snapchat barely worked. So it just made me, like, you know, expand my mind and go do fun things.
That's really fucking cool. I definitely had a real closed mind growing up, and wasn't a very proactive kid. You know, I don't know what kind of, like, negativity I was brought up in, but I didn't want to go look for a job. I didn't want to go do fucking, like, anything that was
Central
too
Coast
difficult
is
to
a
do.
Piece of shit kind of armpit where, like,
but it's
people
also
are,
not
the, we just
like
we're
when
stubborn,
we have the independence,
you know? We're stubborn. No, we don't want to get a job. We want to fucking just do us.
It doesn't matter where we were. It, like, that's just how I was.
Yeah.
It's taken me so long. Like, that's definitely what.
Well, you were the badass, dude. You were the fucking little fucking punk badass kid at school.
But
your whole life. You were just,
no,
like, another version of Matt Diaz.
No way. There, that's
oh, for
ridiculous.
Sure. No, it
I
is.
Was such a fat little nerd.
Dude, you were fat, but when everybody else is small, then you look big. You weren't fat. You were bigger than us. So look at you kick our ass my whole childhood. It's just like Matt Oliver.
Yeah.
You know, that fucker is huge. That guy will fuck you up. Like, you just don't fuck with the people that are bigger than you. You don't even call him fat. Sure. You just hate that word. You always think I'm trying to call you fat. I'm not. I just happen to call everybody fat, apparently.
You're also the maybe my skinniest friend.
Yeah.
Like torso-wise. Like,
dude, I have such a bad appetite.
When you take your shirt off, I hate myself.
Stares at you. I mean,
like when Daniel takes his shirt off, I feel great about myself. Because
I don't even know how to feel about that. Because I feel like I have such a problem with trying to get meals in my body.
That's okay.
You know?
That's okay. You don't need any more than you
like, I strive to get an extra couple pounds. And it just doesn't seem to work out.
Yeah. I take that for you.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
I don't think it's...
What? What do you do? You know what I'm doing right now?
What do you got? You know, I know what you guys are doing. Hey.
Jeez, dude. You don't even let me explain myself.
Damn.
I'm sorry.
Fucking. But yeah, like you have that like sense of adventure that I envy. Like when I see my friends and I see like, oh, you want to go do cool things? Like when I drove up to the wreck in my 4Runner and you're like, this is yours? What the fuck? He's like, you're like, dude, we're going to, I could do, you don't even know what the fuck I could do to this, man. And I was like, damn, like, no, I don't. I didn't even realize 4Runners had such a fucking
culture behind them. When I went out to Maui, my whole life changed on that, like a truck aspect. I didn't give a shit about cars.
Yeah, no.
Or
I
trucks.
I thought people who liked cars were
ridiculous. But then I would
go
camping with my dad in places where you'd ramble over lava rocks for 4 hours straight.
Mm-hmm.
And then you'd be on a secluded beach and you'd just be killing it with fish. And you'd be fucking scoring these waves that are like unbelievable. Nobody's there. They don't know where the fuck it is.
Yeah.
Like, that is life. Like there's
that is life. And that's,
like,
you know what?
It ain't fucking Instagram. It ain't your fucking new pair of shoes. It's like it's getting down to the fucking beach.
If
you know?
Anybody has an Instagrammable life, it's you. And you fucking don't buy into that shit. Like
I do not have a fake Instagram.
So even though like you're my friend and I knew we were gonna do this and I know we can just sit here and bullshit.
Yeah.
You're still a guest on my podcast, so I did like my homework and I looked at people's social media. Yeah, like you know
see,
what I mean?
This is what I mean. I was talking to Garrett and Daniel about this, how people look at Instagram like that now, and that's was scary to me. And I was like, it blows my mind how like Instagram has turned into a bigger thing than like a resume.
It's
like
so terrifying.
Somebody looks
you're right.
at your Instagram and judges so many aspects of your personality, of your like where your drive is in life, and it's bullshit. That is not fair.
Yeah, no, because it's totally tailored, it's curated, but so is a resume.
It is.
You know, I can only put the experience I have and kind of lie about a little bit, and I can only take pictures of things that actually happened and only lie about
it
a little bit.
But both of those things are things we made, you know?
Yeah.
And they're irrelevant when you're going and you're enjoying.
Listen, fucker, regardless. Like, I was even looking at your Instagram and I was like, oh, let's look at the tagged photos. And I was like, I think I have the most tagged photos of Dane and he hasn't lived near me for the majority of our lives.
Yeah.
And I was like, where the rest of your tagged photos? Do you not have a lot? You know what I mean? And it's so cool.
When I lived in Maui, that tagged system wasn't really an Instagram.
Well, and like, so cool though, because like it just speaks to like you don't care about the online aspect to it. You are actually doing cool shit out there. And like what you're doing right now, what you're going to school for and shit. And
I had to drop out.
Really?
Yeah.
When?
You want to know that story? Fuck.
Yeah. You don't have to tell it, but
no,
when did that happen?
So I fucking worked extremely hard on my EMT classes.
Yeah.
And basically it's a 105. The class is 105. You have
not
to take a 106 class.
Okay. Yeah.
3 Saturdays.
Mm-hmm.
And they come out of nowhere. I forgot when I registered for them.
Yeah.
And basically you go to one class and then there's on the first Saturday, the following Friday is the final.
Yeah.
And then you go to class Saturday and then you go to another Saturday class.
Yeah.
Well, I misread the syllabus, and I didn't realize that a final was in the middle of the three classes.
So
what happened was, on Friday, I had a quiz for my 105 class. So I get the quiz done, and I go online, and I'm like, okay, it's like 10:40, and I look at this other class, and it's like midterm due at 10:30.
Wow.
And I'm like, are you fucking serious? And it locks it. It's an online system.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I emailed the guy. I'm like, hey, like, I was busy doing a quiz. I had no idea that the final was like today. Is there any way that I can redo it like tomorrow, or like maybe I could take this class because there's other dates for this specific class like later this year? And he's like, oh no, you can't retake it, and you're not allowed to take a class twice in one semester.
Yeah. Oh fuck.
So I'm like, but if I can't take that, then I can't take the final for my 105 class that I've been in for months.
Yeah.
And on top of that, my 105, it's a pass fail, so you got to get an 80% or higher. And I had a 76%, and I'm like, Jesus. Dude, like, I'm already like on the edge. Like, yeah. I need to know if you're gonna break my fucking dreams for this class or not. He never responded. He just gave me that one sentence, like, can't take the class again. Anyways, time goes fucking on. I stopped taking the class. I'm super bummed. I got an email like 2 days ago saying, oh, you're registered for the 106 class. And because what I did is I tried to register for the class, but it was like, no, you're already enrolled in it.
Yeah.
So you can't take it again.
Okay.
So I gave up on it, but I just got an email 2 days ago saying that I'm registered for this Saturday for a class. And I'm like, fuck you guys, dude. Like, I literally fucking communicated. I gave you all of my time. I talked to every teacher, and then you guys don't even know your own syllabuses. Like, it's, you're setting me up for failure in a sense, you know?
Yeah, okay.
And on top of that, it's coronavirus.
Yeah.
EMT class is an all hands-on class, and I had to fucking do it all online. So it was fucking really difficult. So, I don't know. I mean, I'm glad I'm not doing it right now because I got a lot of stress off my shoulders.
Still do, you could still retake that.
Yeah, I got a... But
If anything, you would do better the next time.
Yeah, granted, that's how I'm looking at it.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, still. It's still... Listen, but it's still like you're doing something like... I don't know any other friends that are like... me, like us, like that are choosing to do something. And
I appreciate that.
You know what I mean? And I don't know, like, I don't hold it against them. I don't go like, what are you, not doing anything? But
we live in a world where a lot of people aren't productive for, like, they don't want to have a lot of self-growth. You know, like, people are just kind of like, this is me, fucking the world should work out. And it's like, the world fucking sucks. You got to put in some kind of grind to get something out of it. You know?
I get stuck in that way of thinking all the time because... It, for the most part, I'm like, well, I kind of just kicked it and like made it this far. Like, why wouldn't it work out?
Mm-hmm.
I think that all the time where I'm like, I think I'll just wait to see what happens. And it's it kind of fucking sucks because you can trick yourself. You can totally convince yourself that that's how it's going to go. And then you're going to go be the famous rock star, God, legend person you hope to be by not doing anything.
Yeah.
And you like go, oh, whoops. So I try to have that talk with myself all the time of like, no, like you're just thinking about this shit. You can do that shit. Worst case scenario, if you try and fail, you're right back where you are, getting nothing, no recognition and nothing done anyways. Yeah. So you might as well fucking try. Like it's almost like gross. Like when we like go back to Central Coast and everyone's like, oh, it's fucking Dallas Bronson for better podcast. It's like, I'm literally no better than you. I just had to choose to like do something.
Dude, I'm so stoked for you that you have the drive to fucking do something else, because a lot of people don't even fucking do shit, you know? Like, they won't even try anything different with their lives. You know, life is so fucking hard, and you gotta like figure out things that really bring joy into your life personally.
Well, listen, with that being said, I'm not knocking anyone who chooses to have like a normal, healthy life where they go to school, get a degree, get a job in that field, and then just meet someone, have kids, you know what I mean? Like, that is a fucking dream. Daniel's mad because he's not doing either one of those things.
It's all jealousy.
You know what I mean? And it's just, it's fucking, like, that's so cool. Like, you know, I used to think, like, oh, those people lost. Those people fucking gave up. Those people suck. They didn't go become actors or rock stars or whoever, like, whatever thing I liked. You know what I mean? Like, I was, like, judging them on this, like, really hyperactive basis. And it's like, no, like, they, if anything, that they did something like that I can't do.
Yeah.
Like that. I should be respecting that. Mm-hmm. And I do. I respect them for that. Like, have the wherewithal to get something done like that.
Yeah.
Because I'm fucking not.
I feel like life is so uncertain that, like, you just got to do something, you know? Yeah.
No.
Even if you're going to school and you're not going to use your degree, like, at least you're doing something productive, you know? Like, you're building your mind. If you're going to go to school, at least, like, the way I did it was, the only reason I really got into college, thank God to my mom, is she helped me out when I was 18 with rent, because she's like, okay, if you go to community college, I'll give you $400 a month from your sister's child support.
Wow, okay.
And so I was like, all right, fucking deal.
That's a sweet deal.
That's what started it. And
now you're still dropping out to this day. You know, that's fucking tight, dude.
Well, basically how it worked is I was like, I don't know what I'm gonna go to fucking college for.
Yeah.
And so you can go do liberal arts, which is general classes. It sucks. It's like going to high school again. Math, science, English. But you basically knock out a whole bunch of shitty shit so that when you go back to school, you can focus on cooler stuff.
Those kids don't get jobs anyways.
What, liberal arts degree? Yeah, fuck it. Yeah, no, it's literally nothing. If you don't do anything with your liberal arts, you don't even go to college if you're just getting that. But I'm just saying, if you want to go there and kind of take your time to think about college, like a lot of people should,
yeah,
because it's such a huge financial obligation. I haven't paid, I owe no money.
Really?
I have an associate's degree.
Wow.
I owe no money.
Well, then, yeah, I know a lot of people who have an associate's degree and don't owe money for it.
It's not that hard. But the thing is I also got accepted to the Art Institute of Los Angeles, and I was going to do videography.
Yeah.
And then by the time I got out, I would have had a $584 a month payment for 35 years.
Ouch. Ouch.
So.
And that interest goes up, and
I wanted to get my associate's and bachelor's, and I was like, my grandpa's like, you could have a fucking brand new Porsche for fucking 35 years. The latest model. That's the type of payments you're going to be paying.
Seriously.
Like, I'm just like, fuck, man. Like, who could, like.
Well, I mean, how many.
If you're going to go to school, think about it. You know, unless you come from a rich family that can afford it.
Yeah.
I don't. I'm all FAFSA. Give me that federal student aid.
No. FAFSA is a pain in the ass. That's why I didn't go back to college.
It is.
Was
it's
because
free money.
FAFSA.
That's why.
Well, no, like I couldn't get them to the program to work. It was like such a pain in the ass. I couldn't figure out how to make it. Like I had to go into the office. They had to talk to me. Like, oh, is this not your social security number? Is this not your login? Is this like, it was literally like a password problem to where like I couldn't access my own fucking. And I was like, fuck it, I'm not going. Clearly, this is a sign I shouldn't be here. So I said, fuck it.
I think that they make it a little difficult on purpose because it's so much money.
Maybe.
They put eight more steps in there. How many millions of dollars did they just save? Or billions, you know?
Interesting. Well, I mean, think about how much money they get from people from who they now owe loans, college loans.
How they get money?
Like all these people, like they're still getting money from people who took out all those loans and then are going to spend the rest of their lives never paying it, being able to pay all of it back and then adding interest on
there's
that.
There's also ways to never pay back your loans, and that's something they don't teach you in school.
Of course not.
And that's what most people in America have to fucking do, and it's not weird. I know somebody who's a marine biologist in Maui who did 8 years of really expensive school.
Yeah.
And she paid like $12,000 for schooling.
Wow.
Because she paid the minimum for fucking like, I think it was, what is the year? It's like 20 years or something. It's something that like, there's a certain amount of time with this loan, and if you don't pay it back, then they drop it. And so...
So it's like a medical bill? You just ignore it?
Yeah. No way. And there's a lot of things in this world like that.
Like medical bills.
Like medical bills.
Yeah.
I've never
Which blows my mind. Like, they don't tell you any about... That. Like, those are the secrets in life that nobody tells you about.
See, that...
No, Gary. Shut up.
Shut up, Daniel.
All right. Podcast. Did you get started skateboarding or surfing first?
Skateboarding.
When did you start skateboarding?
Shit, dude. I've been skating pretty much my whole life.
When did you start? Because I met you. Okay, because I met you when we were 8 years old, 8, 9 years old, second grade.
Yeah.
That's a long fucking time.
I mean.
I don't remember you skateboarding.
I was definitely skating in first grade.
Really?
Yeah.
That's crazy. I didn't start skateboarding until the end of third, fourth grade.
Yeah. I mean, I had a board my whole life.
That's crazy.
Because my dad, he was a pro surfer for a little bit, so he is always skating, surfing.
Always been in that culture.
Yeah.
Okay. When did you start surfing then?
I tried surfing like a year before I moved out to Maui, so I was 15. And, it sucked ass.
Yeah.
Fucking Pismo is cold as shit.
Yeah, it's
and
the
I would
worst.
Go with Ian Malott, and he's the man. But, yeah, I basically got worked, and then I got kicked out, and I lived
in
literally
surf
like...
capital of the world?
Not only that, I was the closest person to Hokipa, which is like one of the most popular surf spots on Maui.
Wow.
I've literally slept closer than anybody. Like, I was right behind Mama's
like
Fish House, which I worked at.
No fucking
and
way.
And my first house ended up being my tool room for that job.
No way.
Yeah. Like, I literally, like, I moved there. It was a one bedroom. I slept in the kitchen, fold out futon. And that's the whole time I lived with my dad was there. But then I left. My dad left. Mama's bought that whole property because they wanted to own the whole street that goes to Mama's.
Yeah.
And
fuck yeah.
That's and so yeah, tight. they fucking gave us that whole bottom. We gutted it and made it into a tour room. Like fucking it was so full circle, it was ridiculous, you know?
Damn. That's fucking tight.
I like broke down my backyard wall and shit. It's crazy.
I don't. I. Yeah.
I can
think,
show you a picture if you want.
I think last year. I mean, you could save it.
I'll show you one day.
Yeah, I'd love to. But I was thinking about surfing a lot last year, or maybe it was this year. But like, I was like, I think I could. I think maybe I should surf. I think maybe that'd be fucking tight. And I remember one time I was sitting on a bus stop when I was 16, 17 years old, talking to this guy from Hawaii.
Do you want to fucking surf?
Listen, fucker, let me finish this fucking story.
Please, dude. I'm getting so horny and happy.
He basically described to me what surfing in Hawaii was like, and he's like, if you ever do anything in life, you need to go to Hawaii and surf. And I was like, this is when I was probably the most closed-minded, because I was in high school, that I've ever been. And he was like straight up convincing me. And I left this interaction on a bus stop with some stranger. He might not have even been real. I might have like been going to board the bus, turned around to thank him, and he not be there. And I'd be like, hey, where's that guy? And they're like, what guy?
Yeah.
He was never there. You've been at this bus stop by yourself. I saw you down the block.
Yeah. Like,
it was fucking, I just left the interaction
of like.
What did
he say about surfing in Hawaii?
You know what? I don't remember. It
just
wasn't
like
what he
magical,
said.
Yeah,
yeah. It wasn't
thing.
What he said. It was how he said it, because the specifics of the interaction aren't really there. But the feeling afterwards of like, I think I wrote it down in like a journal because I was such a fucking homo and I had one of those back then. Like, you know, just such a little liberal arts bitch. And I think I had wrote like, oh, one day like I need to surf in Hawaii.
Yeah.
And I like was like, fat and pale, and
me.
I was like, I'm not going
Come,
to
dude.
Fucking surf.
I will fucking
listen. I swear to God, if we ever go to Hawaii, I will surf. I will fuck a tiger shark in its ass and surf. Like, I will, you know what I mean? I will swim with the fishies. I'll like spear one underwater, cook it at Mama's Fish House, and
there
fucking surf with you. At,
they buy the fish from the fisherman,
Brooks Koepka, or whatever the fuck you just said.
Hokipa,
yeah, that's the one. Sorry, Brooks is my favorite golfer,
yeah.
Professional golfer. Damn.
That's good. That's real good.
Fucking tight. I might be getting a little contact high.
If you want to surf anytime, dude, like, I don't even think you understand how happy I am to take people who want to surf surfing. Like, I'm all about, it's like skating. You know, like when you go skating with somebody and they're like, I want to go skate. And then you go skate with them and they're like, kind of like, whoa, like, we're actually skating. Like, and then you're like, God damn it, dude. You don't want to skate?
Yeah, you know? Like they fake you. Yeah, you know what? Like that happens with the podcast sometimes.
Yeah, I bet.
Like
I
mean, air over there.
Yeah. No, but like surfing's even worse. Like people, I feel like there's this like almost like a sexuality aspect to surfing. Like I go surf. I go to the beach. That comes along with surfing, but that's not with surfing. It's like surfing is an amazing feeling.
You know what? I'm sure this is like a stereotype or like a joke in surf culture, and I'm pretty sure it's like people have heard this a million times. Do you know what made me want to surf?
What?
Fucking watching Point Break.
Oh my
God. No way. How old are you?
No, dude. Point Break is fucking classic. It's a classic, dude. You cannot deny Point Blake. Or Point Break.
Jesus.
Okay, you want to know something funny about Point Break?
I'm getting gangbanged by you guys' fucking weed right now. I need my cigar to feel normal.
Light it up. You want to know something since we're talking about Point Break?
Yeah, what's up?
So they filmed. There's only two of them, right? There's Point Break 2. That was a newer one.
It was a remake.
Okay. Anyways, they're filming Point Break 2 at Jaws.
Yeah.
And I was there. And it basically was the windiest, stupidest day ever on fucking Earth. Like, it was not surfable.
Yeah.
Nobody was surfing. It was humongous, scary, stormy. It was blowing like 35 miles an hour.
Holy shit.
With like 50 foot plus faces. Humongous, scary ocean.
Hey, what's a face?
Before a wave breaks.
Yeah. Oh, in it. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, so before it breaks, that's the face. It's peaking. It's peaking. That big area you're looking at is the face.
So, like, if I have the biggest, you know, when you are like fucking, and at one point when you're fucking, like, your dick is the most erect.
Yeah.
That's like the face of your dick. So it's the most erect a wave gets?
Or you could almost call that the curl.
Well, mine kind of curls to the right.
Because at the top of the peak is the curl, and that is the tippy top before the breaking point.
Okay.
So I would almost put it in that.
Your shaft is the face.
Your shaft is the face.
Okay.
The curl is your
head. The curl would be rock solid.
I feel like my curl would be the curl.
Yeah.
Mine, like I said, curls to the right. Like, mine can peak around the corner before I can.
A wave has a curl regardless.
I could see a threat in my own household if I had an eye on my dick and it was hard and I was walking through it around the hallway first.
Yeah. No, but anyways, okay, so fucking we're at Jaws. They're filming for this thing. And then if you watch Point Break 2, in the movie they're at a whole different wave.
Yeah, it's called editing, you fuck.
Yeah, but
that happens in a lot of movies.
Okay, no, but they fucking edit it like it's in the middle of the ocean. They put so much extra editing into it that they took almost away the wave. And okay, I know you don't really give a shit about that, but as a surfer,
yeah.
It's like, why would you even fucking go to the world's biggest fucking wave to edit out the fake wave? That's like going to El Toro and making it into a six stair. Why the fuck would you do it? There's no point. Go to a six stair.
But the point is,
go to a fucking peak in the middle of the wave they're going to in Point Break is an actual fucking wave.
Stop right there. Stop right there.
They could have gone to it.
Stop right there. I'm making a film and I get the production company and I convince them to give me enough money and be like, so we have to film this scene. The only way we're going to at all compete with the Keanu Reeves, Patrick Swayze Point Break is we're going to have to go to this amazing surf spot.
Yeah,
it's called Joss. It's in Hawaii. We have to go there, but we don't have enough money. If you give us enough money for me, my cast, my crew, my fellow, actors, this movie's going to be a hit. It's going to be a success. This is going to be, we can't replicate or get these shots without going there.
What if I stopped you there and I told you that the wave they use in the movie is in California and it costs more money to take all your production to Hawaii instead of going to the actual fucking wave?
It's not about costing more. It's about, we just got to film in Hawaii and afterwards.
Yeah, my that's dad, more of what
listen,
it is.
Listen,
they just
listen,
wanna
listen,
go to
listen,
fucking Hawaii,
listen,
dude. Fuck that.
My dad
fucking money.
Has built so many things on the Central Coast. He's built things. He got a chance to go to Hawaii for
no,
a
that's
summer.
A thing, for sure.
Just to build a fucking Costco.
No, that's a thing. Yeah. Yeah.
You think he was like,
no, that's the pinnacle
it's part
of building.
Looks, sorry, sweetie, we gotta go. I gotta end my relationship with my son and my wife for the whole summer. Uh-huh. And I know it's gonna, why, you know, gotta put food on the table, so gotta go to Costco. You know what I mean? He fucking lived in Hawaii. He would just catch fish and cook them.
Where did he go? What Costco did he build?
Where did he,
you know what island?
Not Lanai. What?
I mean, possibly that is an
no,
island.
It's not Lanai though. Okay. Oh, man. What? Name a couple of them. I can't remember.
Big Island, Hawaii. It gets confusing.
Keep going.
Maui, Oahu, Kauai.
I think it was Oahu. No, keep going.
It probably was Oahu, because Oahu is like where most buildings.
No, keep going.
Molokai, Lanai, Niau.
It was Oahu. It was Oahu. He built a Costco in Oahu, and he fucking just would like, I know he just would get home from building a Costco, just get drunk, eat fish he caught next to the beach house, and just was living in paradise.
What year was this?
2010? 2009, 2010?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Because they built a Costco in Maui when I lived there.
Yeah, it wasn't Maui.
Yeah, but it wasn't during that time. I also didn't live in Maui at that time.
Oh, so it wouldn't even matter.
No. I did. Yeah, I did.
You'd be 14, 15.
2010 was my freshman year in high school.
How old are you, Dane?
Sophomore year, I moved out there.
Dane, what year were you born?
Well, it would have been right around there. 2010.
But that's not when Costco. That's not when Costco got built in Maui.
What time? What year were you born?
95.
Oh, okay. So I'm the same age.
February 10th. 7 pounds, 7 ounces.
February 10th?
Yep.
Damn.
At 7:07. Okay. That's what my mom says, but who knows what mom say, right?
Yeah, it's like, mom, you know how many fucking drugs you were on?
My mom was like, okay, you want to know my mom's weed story about drugs?
Weed story about drugs?
This was like me growing up, what my mom would say marijuana is. Like, she's like, I smoked weed with your dad, right? And I went into the bathroom and I saw the devil.
Yeah,
I saw his red face with horns staring straight at me, and it scared me out. And so I was like, okay, you're fucking crazy. And then I had to ask my dad, right, when I moved to Hawaii. So my mom's been fucking milking this story my whole life.
Like, yeah.
Tell me the story. And he's like, oh, you want to hear that story?
Oh, shit.
So your mom was like, how the fuck do you just waste your money on weed? All you want to do is smoke and surf and blah, blah, blah.
God bless.
And so, you know, typical fucking just surfer fucking young kid. And so he's just like, fuck you. Like, and she's like, you know what? Let me smoke some. And he's like, I don't have any good shit right now.
Uh-oh.
Because at that time, he didn't always have good weed. It wasn't
like the 21st
shitty,
century.
Yeah. So he had shitty Mexican weed, my dad said.
Okay.
And so he's like, I rolled up a joint, me and your mom smoked, and she goes, what the fuck is this? You waste your money on this. I don't feel anything.
Oh, shit.
You fucking do all this, blah, blah, blah. You don't spend time with me because you want to fucking smoke with people. And so my dad's like, okay. So he says he went and got some crazy fucking weed, the best weed he could fucking find, right?
Yeah.
And he's like, smoke this with me. And she's like, all right.
Uh-oh.
And so she smoked it, and she got crazy paranoid, like super freaked out, panic attack. Because my mom has anxiety, whatever.
Uh-huh.
So she's already like pretty gone. So that's where that story came from.
Okay.
Which is pretty funny.
Well, dude, I gotta tell you, I've eaten some edibles that have made me question my own fucking religion.
100%. Yeah, and that's where she was at. I've been there too, man. There's weed can do
my hands sweaty just talking about it.
Yeah. It's a scary drug sometimes. Yeah. Dabs?
I feel I've never dabbed, and I was literally talking shit about dabs in my last episode.
Good. Yeah?
Yeah.
You've never dabbed?
No.
Oh my god, dude, that's the best time. See, this is.
Let's stop. I'm gonna stop both of you cock smokes right now.
Okay. So
this is what. Listen,
dabs
let's
are
stop
the scariest thing your first time, so that's why you must dab.
Dane.
Must dab.
Dane.
Yes. Keep going.
Daniel too. Shut up.
Argue me wrong.
Listen, this is exactly why I didn't smoke weed till I was 22, 23 years old. Okay. Is because. As soon as I say, like, oh, I've never done that, I have Beavis and Butthead going, "Duh, you've never, no!" And then it's just like, ew, ew. Like, it turns into, like, this is more fun for you than it would be for me. And then it turns out the first time
that's
I smoked
weed,
I bought a fucking Swisher and rolled a blunt with Kylie, believe it or not. Fucking smoked a little weed in my bedroom, and I'd been around weed my whole life. I know what it smells like. I know what being contact high is. I'm fucking getting it right now, you goddamn stoner baloners. And then we just walked, and it just like, and I was like, you know how many people in my entire life from like age 12 to for like the last 10 years, I've had so many people like, oh my god, like if you ever want to smoke weed, like, oh, make your first time be with me. I would love the first time you smoke weed. Like, and it was like that meme you see that's like, no, come on, bro, like I swear, bro, you need to fucking smoke this weed.
You
this
grew
is
up
T, bro,
in the Central Coast, dog.
And just fucking,
you grew up in the Central Coast where, and our group of friends are pieces of shit. So, I mean,
we all have the worst ADD of any like fucking people I know.
But I was also I was against weed for like a long time.
What? What'd you say?
I was against weed.
Me too. I was like, seriously.
Like for a long time, like what happened was like Garrett, he started smoking weed and like.
Well, that's when I like distanced myself too.
He smoked weed and he didn't tell me. And I like got so mad as a
I'd
little kid. I was
I'd
like,
be really upset.
Bro, I thought we were on the same page. Like we're not smoking weed.
Yeah.
And it's so dumb. But like, anyways, he's like, I remember one day he's like, he tells me, like, straight up, like, looks at me like, yeah, dude, I smoke weed with Matt. And I'm like, dude, Matt's a bad kid, dude.
Yeah.
You're lying. And he's like, no, dude, Matt's cool. And I'm like, dude, I don't. And it was because I didn't know Matt at the time. Yeah. I was just starting to meet him. And I was like, Matt's taking fucking Garrett away from me, bro. He's cooler than
shit.
Me, you know? He smokes weed. I don't want to smoke weed, dude. I'm afraid of it because I had a crazy mom that was like telling me devil stories and shit.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, I'd stopped caring. I was like, whatever, dude, smoke weed.
Yeah.
So he would go smoke weed. Everyone, it's not like he was a stoner or some shit.
Yeah.
But then eventually I was like, fuck you, bro. I want to smoke weed. And then I had this thing where I was like, I don't know who to tell anymore because like, Garrett would be the guy I was going to tell, like, I'm going to smoke weed for the first time. But now I told him, like, fuck you, bro. Yeah. Like, you're smoking weed.
Yeah.
So somebody was smoking weed in a circle, and I rolled up on my skateboard.
Mm-hmm.
I knew how to do it perfectly. I planned it out of my head. I was like, I'm just going to roll up when they're passing around the pole, and they're just going to pass it to me, and I'm going to take a rib.
Damn.
And so I did that. I rolled up.
Damn.
We're just talking. So somebody gives me a fucking bowl, and I rip it. I'm like, blow it. Skate away, and then I remember like coming back and just being like, I remember I talked to Gary. I was like, that shit doesn't do anything, dude. Like it's fucking dumb. Like, fucking weed doesn't do shit. And so then like the next day at the rec, I go sit in the treehouse.
Yeah.
And I fucking smoke weed out of a can for the first time.
I never smoked weed out of a can.
That's out of how an new Arizona I am to can. It.
Oh my god.
And I smoked a whole bowl to myself.
Yeah.
So I don't even remember who gave it to me. It might have been Matt. I think it was Matt. Funny. And so me and Matt were up top, and then I smoked a whole bowl, and I was so fucking high, dude. Like crazy high.
Yeah.
Like I got high for the first time. So like my fucking vision was like, I don't know, like almost acid-y. You know?
I was going to say, I did acid years before I smoked weed. So by the time weed was around, I was like, I'm fine. That's pretty easy.
Yeah. The first couple times I got high, like, then I was like, okay, it's kind of cool. So I met this kid, Christian, in Grover.
Yeah.
And I remember, like, he kind of had like a piece of shit mom, and so I was like,
oh yeah. You were like, I can get weed from this kid.
And so I hung out with Christian. He always had super sick skate shoes too. So I'd like always like be like, what is he wearing? And he ripped. He'd get free fucking boards. I don't even know what happened to that kid, but yes.
Sorry, you got to fart into the microphone.
Anyways, he fucking, I'm like, yeah, dude, I smoke weed now. He's like, oh, what, dude?
Oh, what?
Okay, you want to go to my friend's house?
Oh,
and I'm like,
shit.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. So we skate over to this kid's house, right? And it's and I thought he had a bad mom. Like, we go to this kid's house, and, like, the mom brings out a bong to us.
Oh,
and I'm like,
my God.
I'm, like, 14 years old. Like, just, like, or 15. 15. I'm, like, 50. I'm not 14. Yeah. And so I'm like, oh, this is the stuff my mom's been talking about.
This is devil shit.
You know, like, this is the bad, people are doing drugs in here, you know?
Yeah.
And so I remember Christian had the bong. We met his friend, and so his friend took a rip because it was his bong. And I remember, like, I've never smoked a bong before. What do I do? So I'm looking at it. I'm like, how does it work?
You, like do the thing, and you, like, lift it, and there's, like,
and
a
so, like, yeah,
bubble.
I saw him pull it, and I was blown away that smoke, like, went up.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, well, I smoked out of a can the last time. Like, this is totally different.
Yeah, this is a whole new apparatus.
It goes to Christian. I'm like, okay, light, bowl piece, drop, and you're done. That's it.
Yeah.
And so they get to me. I rip it. I'm like, fuck yeah. Put it in. Put on the table. Blow out. Holy shit. Like, high as fuck.
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right, let's... we went to this ditch spot, and I remember just being so visually high, I couldn't believe it. I went to the spider web.
Oh, fuck.
And I got a lighter, and I just started burning away the like, web around it. And I was like, I don't know why that is burned in my head. I don't even know what the meaning of it is. But, like, after that, I went to another kid's house, and we hotboxed an El Camino that was broken. And it was the highest I've ever been in one day. Yeah. Dude, that day I literally felt like I was on like they don't sell that weed.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So that
What'd
was
you
my,
say?
Josh Pankey told me he grinded the like
he told me that too.
Oh my god, yes. That piece of shit, dude.
Hey, wait, stop. Everyone stop right now. Josh Pankey was my best friend for years in elementary school.
Josh Pankey.
We used to build homemade fireworks and bombs in his house. He had a quarter pipe in his backyard that you could only get to on a slip and slide like track. Like, you had to skate the slip and slide across the grass to get to the quarter pipe.
Sounds like Kale's house.
I know, but worse.
Almost sicker.
Sometimes they skated. Well, yeah, because we were spray painting trees and blowing shit up in his backyard. And one time, oh my god, one time.
Where did Josh Pankey live?
On Story Street. One time, you know where Kale lives? Like, right before Primavera, there's a left. You know where Shea Arteaga used to live?
No.
Okay. I don't know. It's the street right after La Placita if you're going out towards the speedway.
Oh.
Stories.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, yeah, I do know.
So he lived out on there. Like, so some super random. One time we got his grandpa to buy us lighter fluid when we were like 10 years old so we could go make Molotov cocktails.
That sounds amazing.
We made a Molotov cocktail out of a plastic bottle and crumpled up
plastic?
Let me finish. Plastic. We didn't have a glass bottle, so we were like, oh, we have this plastic water bottle. Uh-huh. You know, so we crumpled up like an old piece of homework and made that the like fucking the fuse or whatever, like the cloth you light.
Yeah.
And we put it in and we lit the paper.
Wait,
and
was it gasoline?
It was like straight up lighter fluid. Lighter fluid.
Oh,
like
fuck.
In like a big like carton or like the like, you know, the, you know,
damn,
when you see people like spray.
You wasted like a half a bottle?
No, we just like sprayed some in there.
Oh, okay.
And and we fucking we lit the piece of paper and it wasn't doing things, and we weren't gonna like throw it because we're like in his backyard, so we're like it would burn, you know, all of the everything down here, and it was big backyard, so we just kind of like were lighting it and like holding it in our hand, and the fucking paper burned, and then a piece of like ember fell into the lighter fluid. No. And it went, and all the fire, it went, and like the paper went, and it like exploded out of our hands, dude. It was like fucking terrifying. We're like, holy shit. And that, and it was like, hey, we should.
Was it contained in the bottle?
Yeah, but it like blew up out of the mouthpiece. Yeah. And it like scared the shit out of us.
Heavy.
Meanwhile, he had like, you know, like how you can tie a bunch of M80s together and you have like a stick of dynamite. Yeah. Him and his brother just like made like old, like illegal firework bombs like that all the fucking time.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I remember Josh Pinky was, yeah, like that kind of, I was glad you knew him so well, you know, kind of deal. Like, cause me and him were cool because more of you.
Yeah.
You know, like it was like,
I was your Pinky mouthpiece was, and then
All of a sudden I was like, oh, Dallas is boys with them. Like,
no, like so we're cool, oh man. You know? Like, yeah. I know what his dick looks like from like early on. Like we're boys. He's uncircumcised. Sorry, Josh.
Have you ever heard the story of me and Garrett when we went to, we dropped a firework?
No.
Down a pole? Or not a pole,
A manhole?
Manhole.
A manhole. Drain, okay. Yes. Like, okay.
Yeah. I can't think of the word.
No, what happened?
Yeah, that's probably right.
Yeah.
No, not manhole drain. Okay, so you know like foundations, how there's just giant
Like pipes? Yeah, yeah. Like, yeah.
So me and Garrett were like lighting fireworks and we were like dropping them down into this hole, and whatever, having a good time. It falls all the way down, you don't see it.
Yeah,
it must be hella deep.
Oh,
so
no.
Fucking we're cruising, it's me, Garrett, and his brother Nick, and then the fire department came up. And so we're like cruising, and then Nick's like, all right guys, I think I'm gonna go home. And Garrett's like, fuck you, no you're not going home. And like, oh, but me and Garrett are just like, we're just like looking.
What happened? You dropped the firework
we're
in
just dropping
and it,
fireworks?
Did it blow up? Like what happened? Did you hear it? What happened?
Garrett, pass the mic on this one, because
Garrett can tell this, hand it to Garrett.
okay so
this is Garrett.
At the end of my street growing up, it just dead ended, and then there was like this small kind of eucalyptus tree forest.
Yep.
You remember that probably?
Yeah, but the listeners don't, so you got to describe it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's just a street that dead ends, and then there's a bunch of eucalyptus trees, and I think there was a house there previously.
So there was like an old foundation from it left over?
Not even a foundation. So basically, now that I kind of like, now that I'm older and I know what things look like,
yeah,
basically we found a cast iron pipe sticking straight out of the ground, which we didn't know what it was. Just a portal to nowhere in the forest. And we found out when we dropped rocks down it, it made cool fucking noises.
Oh yeah,
it's like,
yeah.
So Dane and my brother are just staring at this fucking hole, and then we realize we have fireworks that we can shove down it.
Amen. So, naturally.
And like, shit you not, I don't even know how the fuck that happened, because like 2 minutes later a whole fire truck is like driving into the forest, like lights on, fucking
everything.
Yeah,
what the fuck,
like, freaked us the fuck out. So yeah, we're like 12, 11, 10, I don't know, around that age. My brother's like 7 or 8. So he immediately, as soon as he sees the fire truck, is like, I'm going home now.
Oh, no.
He starts, like, booking it towards the house. I was like, get the fuck back here. And they basically freaked us the fuck out. They told us it could be an oil well.
Yeah.
They're just saying some shit to scare you.
Basically, like, don't
blow up the whole block, they said.
I mean, they're right, though. We shouldn't have just been lighting shit on fire and dropping it down mysterious holes. Bad shit.
Usually
was probably gonna happen.
Typically, that's so funny. That, you know what? You know how you see those like white and orange poles, like, and it says gas line or whatever. There was one on Josh Pankey Street, and it was like it says like gas line, and I remember when I told him, I was like, oh yeah, if you drop like a bomb or a firework or like a grenade down there, this is what I used to think grenades made fire,
but they just
made fire.
I thought they blew up and there was like a fireball.
Oh,
that's
okay.
In movies. That's not actually how like a grenade fragments to pop. You. It's not like that. So I was like, you drop a grenade down there, you're gonna blow up like this whole fucking block. And I remember the worst person I should have told this. The only other worst person to tell that maybe would have been Jason Pesci. If you guys don't remember, I don't think I knew who that was. He was taken out of my fourth grade class in handcuffs.
Oh shit!
At Dana Elementary,
they handcuffed a fourth grader.
What did he do? He I don't know. The worst part, it was my next door. It was my next door neighbor, a cop, who we were like super tight with, who like came into my classroom and it was like, oh shit, there's John, and I was like, oh shit. He's taking Jason. He's out of here. It was like, I don't know if he was like, I don't remember. Maybe he wasn't in handcuffs, but either way, like the cops came for him and it was something he did.
Like not even involved in school. Like this was outside of school.
He was in school.
Like they were like, nah, we got to go.
He was in school. So there was no like truancy. It was like,
yeah,
we actually have to.
Well, usually,
you
I would
from
like imagine
school.
Like a small child getting arrested at school is for something he did at school, but for him to have done something outside of school that the cops are that interested in.
He used to come to school.
Impressive
in tutus.
For a fourth grader. Wow.
Like he would have black hair dye like dripping down his fucking head and wear like a tutu, like stockings, and like had to, like, I remember me and Josh Pankey thought we were like real punk rock.
Wait,
and anarchy.
He was in, so at, fuck.
Hold on.
He was in at, your fourth grade class.
Yeah. Mrs. Wright, that fucking cunt. And hope she's dead. Jason would like, me and Josh were like, oh, we're punk rock anarchy. Like we love, like we would watch the Anarchist Cookbook and think we were like gonna build bombs and shit.
Yeah.
Like he, which is funny because the staff was like afraid we were gonna be like some crazy like school shooter, like anarchist, like making bombs kids. And this is like third grade. We're like, we just like Ozzy Osbourne and Bam Margera. Like
you guys were really bad kids.
We drew on our shoes. So clearly like we meant bad things, and they like would like tell us about things like making bombs and shooting school and things like that, to where we were just like, oh, we're watching the wrong movies. I think we got to go back to Grey World and find like these. So that's how we found out like what anarchy was and anarchist. I remember we used to look up anarchy in the school dictionaries. Just like fucking write the.
Oh, I remember sometime around that time I had drawn an anarchy sign on my hand.
Always.
And
all the
my
time.
Dad, I remember this now. It's really fucking embarrassing. My dad asked me what it meant, and I think I gave him some bullshit answer, and I totally thought he believed me. But now looking back, he definitely knew what the fuck was written on my hand.
Yeah.
He was like, "What's that mean?" And I said something fucking stupid, like, "Oh, it's just like some." Yeah.
Yeah, you invented this. You might have been there at this incarnation.
Didn't you like listen to all that kind of shit?
Anyways,
my dad liked The Who.
So yeah, no, like me and Josh, once we like found out who Jason was, it was like, oh, he's punk rock. He's total anarchist. Yeah. We used to call people anarchists. Like, oh, he's an anarchist like us.
Yeah.
And
you were right.
Boy, did he like level it up where I was like, I don't think I have to do anything because Jason's got this shit covered. You know what I mean? Oh my God. It's so fucking weird.
God damn. There was like a weird brewing in our elementary school of like punk kids like one-upping like, each other. So there was a bunch of fucking fourth graders with like just all band tees and mohawks. Yes.
Well,
and
no,
shit.
Dude, I remember Josh telling Matt that like he like wasn't like because we didn't know like what Matt came from and what his family was like, and like,
oh, I assumed the gnarliest shit.
I didn't
ever,
so I didn't for the longest time, and I was just like, so Josh was like, not to, I don't mean to drag Josh through the muck, he's probably doing fine, he's a gentleman, but this is just,
yeah, no, I really have no memories of Josh Pankey other than like fourth grade though, so
he fucking, he was like,
he was, I don't know, I think he like accused Matt of like being a poser or something, and Matt was just like, yeah, no, I'm not.
That sounds familiar.
It was weird because so we were like, nah, I'm pretty sure Matt's like faking it. Like he's not like punk like us. And turns out we were completely wrong and we were not punk like Matt.
Oh, no, not at all.
Not at all. And it turns out the first time that I saw Peanut was when I was like in first, second grade.
Yeah.
And he was walking down the street like with like a bunch, there was like Liberty spikes and like bum flaps. Peanut was the first like, and I was like, what the fuck is that?
Peanut was the first punk I ever saw in my life.
My dad like opened my brain. My dad put his hand on my chest and he's like, if you're ever like that, I will fucking punch you in the face. Like said some shit like that. And I was like, oh, that sucks. Cause that looks like the coolest thing ever.
Uh-huh.
So I spent the next like 10 years trying to be like that essentially. And, anyways, hand the fucking microphone back to Dane now.
Yeah.
This is his podcast. You'll get your chance another time, Gary.
I just had to tell you a story about holes. Dropping shit in holes.
Yeah. Dude. It,
Hold the up. Worst part was...
One more bonger.
That those fucking firefighters made us tell our parents on... Like, they made us rat ourselves out. Dude.
Yeah.
Oh, they would have like, go home and tell your parents... Or, go home and tell your parents, or else we're going to come by with the... The
so they didn't make you rat on your parents. You fucking ratted your ratted
ourselves out
yeah.
Because he threatened like way more worse shit was gonna happen.
Yeah, and you're 12.
Yep. We're already like, no, we're like 10.
Panicky.
Like, adrenaline was pumping.
Yep. All right.
Yeah, I ratted myself out. Didn't even need to.
Jesus.
Like for sure. Absolutely.
We dropped a firecracker in an old sewer.
Or Josh Pinky framed you guys and lit a real fire after.
So, Dane.
Yes.
All right. I'm taking it back to Dane now, guys. You get in some of the funniest fucking conflicts and like incidents with people. God. First of all, you got us kicked out of Taco Bell when we were 12 years old. And as the lady was telling us we need to go, you were like, fine, we're fucking leaving, you fucking bitch. Like, you said some, like, you were like, all right, I fucking heard you, bitch. You, like, said that shit. And I remember sitting there, and that's one of those other moments where I was like, oh, like, me and Josh Pankey aren't punk rock. Dane is punk rock. Jason Pesci is punk rock. Fucking
hell yeah.
Matt Diaz is punk rock. Like they're like the real deal. And it like it was another. It was one of the most eye opening of like.
I'm just. I'm kind of a bitch.
When
I'm a
sure
very nice
yourself.
Guy, but I definitely can fucking break and. I'm like a half and half. My mom's like a fucking angel, and my dad's like a stoner surfer fucking donkey. So fucking. Okay. Yeah, I'm right in the middle of there.
Can I play the audio to the video you sent the group chat?
Sure,
of
because...
you in the car.
You want some backstory?
No, I want no backstory. Right. I want to play this
better
first.
Without backstory.
Do you know how
fuck
many dick pictures and like shit I have to scroll through to find this?
Let me just say that this happens multiple times probably around San Diego to people. There's so many fucking bad drivers here. It's fucking ridiculous. I also did nothing.
You didn't do anything. I believe you. Literally, all right, guys.
People are crossing the street illegally in a row. There's five people just separately crossing the street in the middle of the street.
This is his story now.
It's fucking trash.
All right.
Side story. Fuck
that. So this is just a slice of the person Dane is and can be, and also one of the absolute fit. Like, I'm sometimes afraid
no more bullshit.
Of where we're going to get.
No more bullshit.
You're one of those people who, like, the way you look, I could take you home to my parents, but I can't take you anywhere. Sometimes you know what I mean.
Damn
like, we're
damn.
Listen,
right.
listen.
I mean, I guess that's good and bad.
Listen, you little frat boy. I'm just yeah. It's like Kale. Well, Kale, I can't take him home to my parents.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can see him through a window, I guess.
Yeah. listen. If anyone needs to be socially distanced, it's Kale through like plexiglass, and we could just.
Put Kale in a pod.
All right. For those of you listeners who are curious, there's two very powerful episodes I have with Kale Nicholson. Just search the Kale, like the superfood. All right. Let me play the video that reminded me what a gem of a person Dane is. I'm just going to play the audio.
Yeah, fucking leaving. Get the fuck away from me. Go. Learn how to fucking drive, you dumb bitch. Keep fucking bitch and fuck you.
Fuck that bitch, dude.
Listen,
fuck that bitch. I was about to throw a Starbucks fucking glass bottle underneath their tires, but I realized I'm a nice person. And so I pulled over and bitched her out. I wanted to hear her problem.
Listen.
She fucking stopped and then, okay, no. Now you get to hear the story. You don't get to not hear the story.
Yes, I can't wait.
All I did was try to get a car wash. Yeah. You know, I was just going to go get a car wash. I think I had work that day, so.
Yeah.
Going to get a car wash. Look over. The car wash is packed. Got to do a U-turn. So I got to get into the left lane. I'm in the right lane.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, a car, I can't get into the left lane. Somebody won't let me in with my blinker.
Yeah.
So I'm like, all right, well, tough blinker shit, on, I'm cruising.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whatever. Car flies in front of me with no blinker and brake checks. And then I'm like, okay, so I fucking go into the lane that I want to be in.
Yeah.
And I go to the turning lane. That car goes into the turning lane behind me, gets on my ass. And I'm like, I really didn't even notice it, but I kind of was just like, okay. So I fucking U-turn. I go up by the car wash. She like flies past me, and she has like a passenger, and they're just like two like black ladies just like with their arms in the air. They're just like, ugh! And I'm just like, what the fuck? And so I'm going home at this point. I did a U-turn to head home.
Yeah.
So there's a couple ways. You can go straight and then make a left. Or you can make a right and go over the bridge. And I wanted to do the scenic route.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I actually didn't. But this bitch went fucking in front of me and then made a right to go towards the scenic route.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh, what do you know? I'm going right now, bitch. So I'm fucking behind her. She stops in the middle of the road.
Oh, my God.
And so I go around her. She gets on my ass.
Mm-hmm.
And I, like, slow down. And I'm just like, I put my head out like, are you fucking serious? Like, are we just going to keep...
Yeah.
Leapfrogging, yeah. Like, yeah. For real? So we fucking get to the stop sign and make a left. Follows me. She gets on my ass, and I'm like, fuck this. I'm almost next to my house and shit.
Yeah.
And so I fucking get the camera out.
Oh, yeah.
She's on my ass. I know a stop sign's coming up. I pull way to the right, pull my fucking window down, and I'm just like...
And this is when this happens.
She came up and just said, yeah.
Yeah, fucking leaving. Get the fuck away from me. Go. Learn how to fucking drive, you dumb bitch. Keep fucking bitch and fuck you.
Oh, my God.
That's me at my best.
If I was rich, I would have, like... I wouldn't have done anything. That was one of the best moments.
I'm really not the person to look out for those moments, honestly. Like, I really am not. But, like, there is definitely a time and a place for me where I don't take any shit.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not even I think about it. It's just like, you're blatantly a fucking asshole.
Yeah.
And you're in the wrong and you're just pushing on your emotions to me.
This happened to me. This happened to me. Like, shit happened to me like this in Lompoc, and I was driving and I took a fucking video afterwards.
Uh-huh.
This dude fucking wouldn't let me over, and then I tried to change lanes to get behind him and then eventually get over, and he fucking cut me off and brake checked me. And I was like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, I wasn't even...
Yeah.
Like, this is a small town. Like, I was like, I'm not even... we're not driving even aggressive enough to like
start
like,
something.
I was so not in the fucking moment. So then I literally just changed lanes. I had been doing jiu-jitsu, so I was like, I had like inner peace where I was like, okay, I can fucking relax in a stressful situation. I'm not gonna get all, you know, violent, like flared ego, get mad and shit. So I just changed lanes and wait for the light to turn green. And I leave, and his car's like stopped there. So I was like, this motherfucker's waiting for me. He stopped in the lane next to me. He's trying to fucking say some shit. He's going to do some shit. So that's actually why I have the all the little poppets in my vehicle, like in my ashtray to this day. So I can throw them at other cars.
Nice. That's a good move.
Because it doesn't hurt them, but it fucks people's up when they hear on their car. Go, oh shit.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, it's a harmless defense. Damn, harmless offense.
That's a fucking genius move.
I am a genius. So so I'm driving by and I'm like, that's it, dude. I swear to fucking God. What could it be? What could he say?
Yeah.
That is gonna make him be in the right in any way, shape, or form. And you know what happened? As the light turns green and I'm driving away, this mother's fucking asshole's car died and he was stuck in the lane.
No,
and it was like, oh, I hope that last little spurt of cutting me off was worth it, asshole. And I just got to drive by and he's like, and people like honking behind him, and I just get to flip him off and go, fuck you, and drive away. I didn't do anything wrong. He did.
Wow.
And it was like instant karma. It was like one of those things.
So good.
Dude, I literally had to take a video after because I was like, I need to tell someone, but no one's in the car with me, you know? And so I like was like, I told the story and I was like, and his fucking car died.
Unbelievable.
Oh my God. I haven't had, like, how many times do you get instant karma? The only other time where, like, I was, like, wishing something would happen to someone, and it did, was there's this little piece of shit kid I hated on the block growing up, and I still, like, you know, think the worst of him. And you know when someone's, you have, like, little thoughts that can make you angry for the rest of your life?
Oh, yeah, just dude, like, Matt Pike, dude. That fucking kid, I hope he's
Matt
dead.
Matt Pike? Who's Matt Pike?
There's one person in this world that I don't like. Pine?
Yeah.
Good. I hope I don't like, even know his
Matt,
name
Matt,
anymore.
Isn't Matt Pike from Sleep the guitarist? Isn't that?
Oh, I just got Tyler Pike and Matt. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Matt Pine. Yeah. Go back to your shit.
Okay. Yeah. We're going to revisit that in a second here.
Fuck that kid.
Anyway, it was just this little piece of shit kid who always like tattled and was always getting like us and everyone on the block in trouble, and his parents always believed him and none of us, even though he was always the one causing shit. And one time I saw him shit his pants, and I like, you know when you can tell someone shit their pants and they get like that tight duck walk, and he was like, guys, I gotta go, you know, I'll get there. And I know you guys know
you
him too.
You watched him shit his pants?
I watched him shit. I watched this kid shit his pants. This isn't even. Yeah. Wow. I remember watching him shit his pants in front of me. It was the greatest thing.
Was he looking at you?
He was just like hanging out with like kids. You know, like kids just hanging around the block doing whatever the fuck, you know, on like a suburban.
I mean, but like, was he like, I'm going to shit, and then he looked at somebody like, I'm caught, and then he shit?
No, it was literally just like, I was learning to tic-tac in my driveway, and like some neighborhood kids were out playing, and like my next door neighbor, the cop, his daughter Megan was out there, like, you know, doing jump ropes, skipping rock, fucking, you know, throwing rocks at the black neighbors. I don't know, some shit like that. And
long poke.
No, this is Napomo.
Oh, this is Napomo?
Napomo.
Dude, there's like four black people.
Yeah, I was.
There's James, his mom, and
Dylan Holsizer. Anyways, so I was like just kind of like watching him, like, I fucking hate this kid. Like, he's. Oh, you know what? I just remember, dude, I could throw a fucking rock through the window of the shit. I just like just came flooding into my head,
dude,
right
let
now.
Let it out.
Holy shit.
Just fucking let it out. Go.
Oh my God.
Open it.
Holy
open the mouth.
Holy shit.
I can't
say who this is.
All right,
because
well, just
it
tell me how much hate you have in words
me?
Instead of their name.
This motherfucker, I was sitting in my dad's truck that had been broken down in our driveway, and my parents had like separated or something and like had left, and I was just kind of like sitting in my dad's truck, and he didn't live with us at the time, and I was like really, you know, like damn, like my fucking, can you put the fucking gun down, dude?
Yeah, this is story time.
Anyways. Okay.
I look over. He's got what the fucking
put the Glock down.
It's up. Chill.
No, no. Larry point June. It down. Your neighbor's down there. Put the fucking. Anyways. And I was sitting there, and I was sitting in my dad's truck, like just missing him. I was like looking through his like old tapes or whatever, and he. The kid came up and he was like, "Oh, do you miss your dad?" And I was like, part of me was like, I couldn't believe he fucking said that because it was so like, damn, he got me. Like, yeah, I missed the fuck out of my dad. I'm caught dead to rights. I am in my fucking dad's truck. He's gone. I'm nearly in tears, just like thumbing through his old like tobacco, like stuck in the fucking cup holder. So I pull out a baseball bat that was in my dad's truck, in the back of his Toyota truck, like behind the seat, and I fucking chase him with it till he ran home. I never got him though.
Like to his house?
Yeah,
like
not directly across on the corner.
Okay, but the one next to the corner.
I don't know, little blonde kid.
What would you have done if you caught him?
What do you mean? We wouldn't be talking because we wouldn't be having conversation right now because I would have turned his blonde hair into red hair. I would have turned him into a ginger.
Oh, dude, yeah,
I would have beaten him to death with it.
Anyways,
it was fucking funny. Like he got me. He was like, "Oh, and someone missed your dad." He's like 3 years younger than me. He's like 3 or 4 years younger than me. I was like,
damn.
Just got roasted. And I remember the fear in his eyes when I came out with a baseball bat. He went. He fucking booked it down the street, like his life, because it did depended on it. Oh, you know what? It's so funny, the fact that you're holding a gun. So my first airsoft gun I ever got, my parents, they brought it home. This is how much I fucking hate this kid. They brought me and my brother airsoft guns home from the swap meet. Thought it'd be cool if we would shoot each other, leave them alone so they could, you know, do meth. So they
bought two bong rips.
So so the first thing I do with this airsoft gun is I run down the street because I know this little fucking cunt kid is out there playing. I can hear his whiny voice, and I hide behind the neighbor's like retaining wall front yard. I'm hiding behind like the brick wall in front of that divides the houses, and I see him like bend over because he is such a little bitch. He was probably bending over for the neighborhood boy to butt fuck him and molest him. And so he was fucking, he like bent over something, and I was like, now's my chance. Mind you, my dad bought me guns, BB gun, things like that Oh, I have another funny story after this that just happened over Thanksgiving. since I was like in kindergarten, like I was learning how to shoot. So I've been a good shot, like accurate shot, for a very long time. Mind you, I'm maybe 9, 10 years old at this point.
Okay.
He bends over.
Yeah.
I go, now's my fucking chance. I point the pistol at him and I shoot him right in the fucking ass.
Bullseye.
He had no idea what hit him. He's just like sitting there, like getting fingered by the neighbor or something. And just rips into it, goes, and he starts crying. And mind you, I know this makes me sound like a psychopath or a bully, or I might be demented. And I'm not saying I'm not. But when it came to this kid, if someone younger than you could be like your tormentor or your bully, it was this kid. And the sheer,
was he older?
Like, I just said he's 3 years younger. You're not fucking listening?
I'm high. Oh, sorry. Okay.
I'm high. It's just like, if there's someone that's younger than something you that could be your like bully or tormentor, it was like totally out of a fucking like movie. It was like in Step Brothers when he talks about this, him getting bullied and he takes it to the
fucking
kid.
Lick it.
Was this kid
lick the white shit?
Yeah, lick the white shit. So now he could never like physically bully me. I would beat him to death like what I could have with the baseball
bat. Your
whole
life you were bigger and wanted to kill people.
That's not true.
Yeah, dude, that's what you looked like.
Okay, well, that is what I looked like, but I didn't want to kill people until
now.
Yeah,
2020.
Yeah, 2020. Yeah. No, anyways, I don't want to kill anyone. Except
Daniel does. He has a Glock in his hand. He's been holding it. It's hot.
Jesus fucking Christ. Anyways, I shot him right in the ass.
And that older kid's...
What did he do? Did he, like, confront you at all?
No, he fucking shot up. He didn't know what hit him, literally. Started crying, and I was just, like, pistol in hand, like... and, like, booked it back to my house, because I was like, I'm getting a shitload of trouble for this. I better go bring the gun home and turn it into the cops now, because, you know, my parents, like, I'm definitely fucking...
fucked.
Like, I had...
I was never allowed to have one of those when I was younger.
That was the first thing I did with this gun and the only thing I did with it because I hated him so much. It was so worth it to not have a fucking new toy to play with. I was like, I know what I'm going to do. So I shot him right in the ass. So good. I don't even remember what happened after that, but the worst...
Yeah, man.
The karma was he was standing across the street one day and we had the street sign. I lived right on the corner, so the X of the street sign was right across the street from my house. And for some reason, one of the bolts had fallen out. And so it was like kind of like tilted. It was hanging off the top of the pole. Mm-hmm. And I was sitting there in my garage just, you know, probably like watching my dad pack up his shit or something to move out. And I was sitting there and I was like... I was like, God, if you even exist, you would make this sign fall on this fucking kid right now. And for whatever reason, God was listening. That sign fell and smacked him on his shoulder and almost crippled the poor dumb fucking piece of garbage, that lop, that wasted sperm, that crooked... Remember lop? Lop. That's a Napomo term. It means dead sperm.
Chotch?
Oh, so good.
Bring back chotch.
Yeah. How long have we been doing... Oh, not bad at all.
Yeah. Good. I feel like when I'm with Kale, I have to talk like I'm 16.
Oh, 100%. As soon as he starts saying the fish's bunghole was gaped, I'm like, it's on. It's fucking on.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I miss him so much. I hope he's doing well.
I love him.
I wish he was here right now, but also it would be too much.
Kale is... He's the only person that's too much that I, like, 100% accept it. You know?
I don't know if there's anything Kale could do that I wouldn't be like, he's still my friend. I grew up
with, like, all of that it's normal. You know, like,
there's so many.
I know that it's not normal to a lot of people, boner, but like all poop, those
fart, butthole,
yeah, like gay shit,
pussy. He
the shit we've all gone through is ex-girlfriend. Unbelievable.
He fucking sucked my ex-girlfriend's titties on Halloween when we were 12 years old. Hey, gave her a hickey.
I fucking moved to Maui. I come back and he's fucking like Hugh Hefner of Tinder. It's fucking hilarious. I'm just like, of course you are.
Okay,
aren't you a porn star?
I'm not trying to.
I wish I could be. And it's just like,
I'm not trying to put you on the spot. But did you listen to his last episode on my podcast?
No,
dude. Oh my god. It's okay. I tell all my friends. I was like, I'm not offended that you don't listen to my podcast. I'm not for everyone. I'm not even for me. Sometimes
it's
not even like that.
It's just you know me already. I'm not even a podcast guy, and I will listen to a podcast and it will be yours.
I appreciate it.
But it's just I need to think about it.
I said I'm not putting on spot. I don't need to know. I don't want to know. It doesn't, Dane extra thinking it doesn't do is anything a lot for sometimes. Me. Yeah, I get it. Yeah. I mean, I get
but
it.
But I love you.
Like,
I get to hang out with you, which is better.
Yeah, God. You know? You sound like, oh, son, why would I come to your play? I get to I get to see you when you come
home.
Why
won't you just accept your shitty stepdad?
Fuck.
Like, God damn it, I get you whatever you want, and all you do is bitch.
I am so thirsty.
I got you a podcast.
My throat is so fucking dry from
I drove you to the skate park today.
I need a drink.
Sandwiches.
I'll bring it back. I'm going to pause this in a second. Holy shit, dude. Hey, Bad Etiquette listener, if you're enjoying the show and would like to support the podcast, you can donate to our PayPal at paypal.me/baddallas. Okay, and we're back. Yeah, so I don't even know where we were, what we were talking about. Yeah, so sorry, I went a little psycho tangent there. Hope that happens. Kid's okay. I'm sorry, I meant the opposite.
I'm sure I did that too. Today.
Yeah.
What else you got on that sheet?
Oh, so this is just a little bit of note. You know how I said I was doing homework for people? Like
I want to know what my homework is.
Well, it's really just like
talking points. What did you learn from me?
You know what? I just really wanted to know a little bit more about you and what drives you as a person, because you're very interesting. And even though, like, you are in the cast of our friends, I think there's, like, something really fucking unique and interesting about all of you, and I just want to fucking figure it out. You know what I mean?
I feel it.
Like Daniel has such a weird background. Like Garrett, I've known as long as anyone, and so I've known you as long as anyone. And there's still like so many personal things, and like, you know what? Honestly, what it is I'm still trying to reconcile the fact that my parents moved me away from all my best friends when I was 12 years old, and I never got to have like adolescence with you guys, and we missed out on like. Like, I felt like I had to put life on pause, even though it kept going.
Yeah.
So I have, like, this closure problem.
So when did you come back?
I came back for a brief period when I was 16, and that's when Garrett had his Green Forerunner, oddly enough. So I hung out then.
Well, you went to Mesa, too, right?
Dude, I went to Mesa.
But you're just on and off. That was more of, right? You would, like, come to school for, like...
No, I only went to Mesa for a month.
That's
the first month of seventh grade.
Okay. Really?
And that's wow. Dude, that was when I say that that was like the greatest period of my life, because it's like, oh, it's fucking school time and we get to is that Bruno?
It's our group chat.
Oh, it's our group chat?
Yeah. Should we answer?
Yeah, what happened? What's going on? Hey.
Who the fuck are these guys?
Hey, you're on a podcast.
What's up?
Oh, shit, my bad. I didn't mean to.
Oh, is that James?
What's up, James? You're on Dane's podcast.
James, I love you. I was just thinking about you.
Jesus Christ.
What are you guys doing?
Podcast? Hey, Kale?
Who is
that? Kale? Who's on here?
Wait, so who started this shit just now?
Yeah.
Is that Kale?
It looks like Dylan. I didn't start anything right now. I didn't start anything. I answered the call. Yeah, I answered the call too. That's what I'm asking. Dylan? Who started this? Like, who is this?
Dylan definitely fucking started.
Dylan started this, you little piece of shit.
You guys are fucking lying.
Dude, it's always you, Dylan.
I didn't start anything, I swear to fucking God.
It was probably me, bro.
I'm on the phone with Clara right now, and I just... paused her to talk.
Yeah, well, I was jerking off and you interrupted.
We are more important. I was thinking about you and Clara jerking off.
That's funny.
My dick went soft.
Who's on here right now? I hear like...
Is that Kale?
Yeah, Kale.
Here. Kale, this is Kale. And James and Dylan, whoever. This is Dallas, Dane, Garrett. We're all in the same fucking room. I didn't even have to answer my group chat. That's right. We're recording my podcast right now.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You guys are on my podcast.
Can I get a few words?
Yeah. Who's this?
You better shout me out, bitch.
Go for
it. MC Bob. Okay. I've never been on a podcast before, but I just wanted to introduce myself and say, go Bengals.
That's my favorite sports
Bengals?
Team.
Wait, the Bengals?
So who's going to come forward and say that they started this? Because no one said it yet.
It's you son of a bitch. I'm talking into the microphone like it's going into the phone, but...
Well, Dallas is on his podcast right now, so I think he started it.
No, it's definitely James.
Yeah, because it was in my pocket and I just answered it. I probably started it.
Oh, that's so endearing. Just walking into work, ready to get another award of recognition.
Nah, it's like I took my last break and then I fucking came in and I just took my phone out of my pocket and you guys were there.
Bro, fucking close Home Depot.
Dude, they won't. It's fucked up.
I mean, just use the key. That's how you close it. That's it.
Lock that gate up.
Oh, nigga, wait,
is Dane in there too?
Yeah.
Yeah.
God damn it, Kelly, you're dumb.
Kale, you're fucking retarded. Your brain's full of cum, and that's it. You fucking lop.
Dude, I haven't jerked off in a couple days, so that's...
I know, that's why... there's war breaking out in the Middle East because you haven't jerked off.
I tried to have it pile on.
So the next time I, you know, jerk off, it's better.
Big, big love.
You know?
Yeah.
Big boys.
Does that work? I was recording a podcast with Dane, and you guys called, and this rude ass answered it. Well, I think we said answer it. I think we agreed to answer it.
Oh, shit. Yeah, they'll definitely
need
that.
Oh, shit.
It's all right. I want you on my podcast.
James, I love you.
James, I would love if you were...
Wait, so you pocket chatted everybody? Yeah.
Damn, I pocket ignore calls.
Dude, I pocket purchased something like a few days ago too, and I'm trying to get pocket my money purchase? Back. Fucking asses.
Pocket purchase is impossible.
Dude, no, I somehow did it.
Do you have like an Android phone?
I have an iPhone.
Oh, okay.
And what? How the fuck do you pocket purchase anything?
I have no idea. I must have like fucking did my password. I bought like, you know, the Lumen face.
Yeah.
Yeah, I bought that shit.
With facial recognition.
I spent $67 on something. I was so mad, bro. I was like, what the fuck?
What does that have to do with you showing me your sack?
I tried to cancel that shit, and they were like, oh, you gotta re-mail it back to us, and then we'll send you your money back when we get it. I was like, fuck that.
Wait, so shut the fuck up. What does that have to do with you showing me your sack?
I can't do it right now, man. I got a lot of people.
I'm like, show me your sack. I do. I spent $67 a month.
Oh, I didn't hear you.
You're an idiot. You know what's funny? I don't think I've ever seen your balls. Come on now.
Let's do it. Come on. My balls.
Is this a video chat?
No, it's not. That's why it's fucking lame.
Yeah, we
should. I grabbed them so I know. So
switch
I know
it.
They exist, but I
can you?
You showing me naked in the shower, bitch. And you still have those pictures. Delete those naked. Fucking pictures.
Oh shit, oh. There he is. Oh, it is a video chat. You dumb bastard.
Hey.
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 Showed.
Hey. Hey, say hi to my friend. Hey.
Oh
hey.
My god.
Hey, what's up, friend?
You got nice legs.
Stop walking away from me.
Hey, nice legs. Where you walking?
What, you can't see anymore, Dylan?
He's probably going to...
I gotta answer this shit.
All right.
Oh, damn it.
Well, let's continue with the podcast with face
yeah.
time.
I can't, bro. This girl almost saw me like you guys.
Do you have handheld microphones?
Which microphones aren't handheld? You can hold any. Oh my god, listen.
Yeah. Suck my balls.
There's so many fucks. Dude, my dude, you know how many people turned the podcast off just now?
Why am I on two screens? Bitch, look at how many muscles I have.
Oh my god. There's no one listening to this podcast anymore. They're fucking done.
We're fucking up this podcast hard.
Garrett, you turned your camera off.
Damn it.
This is amazing.
This is music. We're making music.
Damn, what is going on? God damn it, I can't
left.
Think.
I'm done. Poor.
Hey, hey, give me a Milwaukee set, James.
James, tell that customer. Did he mute us?
Yeah.
Kale, you look like you're not aging like milk anymore. I gotta take a picture. Not me, bitch.
I'm a fucking minority. You're a dumbass.
What does that have to do with him being a dumbass?
Hey, are you driving?
Yeah.
Kale, you really shouldn't be driving and talking on the phone, you dumb son of a bitch.
I'm not on the phone. It's right here.
You look like a fucking
Uber driver. Kale, you look like you've lost weight recently.
Yeah, Kale, you're getting like two stars on this drive.
Hey, what kind of snacks you got in that Uber?
I have a margarita and
damn.
What kind of margarita?
It's a mezcal margarita with
You have no idea what a relevant compliment that is. All right, okay. Everyone who's listening, I apologize for the phone bullshit. I hope you're back and checking back in with us.
The phone bullshit?
Yeah. Oh, with that video. Oh, also Daniel's gone. He's getting his beer. So we all had the video chat on Instagram, and it was like three of us plus everyone in there. So there's this big like.
This is the boys' podcast, then?
It is now, essentially.
Yeah, dude. I want all the boys on my podcast.
Yeah, is that on? Yeah. Okay, cool. Sometimes I just have to ask. Anyways.
Turn my headphones up.
Turn them up. I can't hear it. Louder.
Louder.
What?
Anyways, yeah, I would happily turn into Ron White. He just sold his Beverly Hills mansion, dude. Or is selling it. There's a video, like a realtor's video, like just following him around about. It's so fucking hilarious. And Dave, it's also tight as fuck.
You'd probably appreciate this.
What?
Have you ever heard my Dave Chappelle story?
No. Yeah. What? You have a Dave Chappelle story?
Yeah. It's pretty good, too.
Like the comedian?
Yeah. So my 19th birthday, Dave Chappelle came to Maui, and my dad got...
For your birthday?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, it was on my birthday. It was February 10th.
Oh, yeah?
And so we went, and my dad got us third row seats.
No fucking way. I don't think I've ever been that close to like...
But this is Maui, so it's not like it's impossible to get those, but it is still a little hard. But he got them.
Yeah.
And he had one extra. And so there's this guy I know, Coconut Willie.
Yeah, of course. Coconut Willie.
Yeah.
It's on Maui.
Everybody, okay, so just you know how that name kind of already makes you kind of...
Yeah.
Okay, so...
It's because of Blast.
We bring Coconut Willie because his chick, she was super cool. I always thought she was like a genuine girl, but she had a baby.
Yeah.
And everybody was like, oh, yeah, that's Will's kid. She's like, yeah, that's your son.
Oh, shit.
And then one day it was not, you know.
Okay.
And it was just like everybody was like, whoa. Like, they were kind of like that perfect couple.
Oh, yeah.
And so it was like who are they going to?
Like me and Kylie.
Yeah. So it's just like one of those things where you're like, I don't even know where they would both go. Because he's kind of... He's Coconut Willie. He's kind of like stoner.
Yeah, might be a little like super, dependent on her.
I love
maybe.
Him.
Yeah.
He helped me out with work. He's a man. But anyways, that bitch fucking totally fucking two-faced him. Unfortunately, he had no idea.
What does this have to do with Dave Chappelle?
Anyways, he's really heartbroken. It happened that day.
Okay. Sorry, I wasn't trying. Willie. Yeah, of course.
Coconut Willie's in there, and he. He's texting his girl, right? Because they're in the middle of this huge, giant thing.
You can't do that anymore at Dave Chappelle shows. That's funny.
Nobody knows that in Maui, that you can't have a phone during...
Well, no, he locks phones up now.
I know, but that... Okay, so that was already there during that show.
Yeah.
But people are still in Maui, and they don't give a fuck sometimes.
Yeah.
And so everybody respected it. Nobody had their phones out.
Of course, it's a show,
but it was a big deal. So anyways, Dave Chappelle is going on... And my dad's all drunk and having a good time. And he fucking yells, like, it's my son's birthday. It's my son's birthday. And I'm just like, motherfucker, dude. And so he's like, what? And he's like, it's my son's birthday right here. And he's like, it's your birthday? And I'm like, yeah. He's like, how old are you turning? And I'm like, 19. He's like, oh, 19. Okay. And then he, like, I really wish I remembered the full joke, man.
Yeah.
But it was a joke that has to do with me jacking off.
Oh, fuck you. Yeah.
So he's just like, oh, 19, blah, blah, blah. Probably jacking off a whole bunch, basically.
Yeah.
And so I'm like, and the whole audience laughs at me.
Oh,
and so
mortified.
I'm like, motherfucker. And then he's just like, don't worry, your dad's still doing it, too. And so I'm just like, fuck yeah, you know, like, you're the man. And he's like, do you have a phone to my dad?
Yeah.
And he's like, no. And I'm like looking at him like, what the fuck? Like, he does have a phone and
he's
like, dumb retard. I don't even know why he said no. So then he looks at me, do you have a phone? And I'm like, yeah. And so I bust out my phone and I go to walk it up and the security guard like, hold me. You can't like
give it to him. And I'm like,
oh, weird.
What the fuck? He's like, give it to me. So I give him the phone. Mm-hmm. He hands it to Dave Chappelle. Yeah. And also, in the middle of that conversation, Coconut Willie is texting, right?
Yeah.
So a security guard, in the middle of our conversation, because he's looking at me because I'm in the middle of the show, he spots him. And so he comes up and he takes his phone. And this was the second time.
Yeah.
So he takes Coconut Willie out. In the middle of the conversation, and I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa. And my dad's like, hey, whoa. Like, no, like, that's the man. Like,
God.
Everybody in the audience knows this guy.
You're like, you can't take Willie out. Yeah.
So we're all like, bro, this fucking Coconut Willie. Like, go get him.
Yeah.
Like, and then he's like, what is his name? He's like, Coconut Willie. His name's fucking Coconut Willie. And I'm just like, and everybody's like, yeah. Like, oh, yeah, his fucking name's go fucking get him.
Jesus.
And so he's like, okay, let me see your phone. And so then he gets my phone.
Yeah.
And... here, let's see. I got the video on my Instagram.
No fucking way.
Yeah. And so he takes my phone.
I'm an aspiring stand-up comedian. You have a picture of Dave Chappelle you never fucking showed me or told me?
I have a video.
You have a video?
And then I have a video. Okay, also at the end of it, look for me and my dad standing up. And you can see us. It's fucking great.
Okay.
It's fucking great.
Oh, dude. My God. Is there a sound? Well,
it's like honestly one of the sick. Here it is.
Okay. No fucking cock sucking way.
Ready? Hold up. Let me go back.
Where is it? Scroll. There it is. God. He said, Will, you fucked up.
Yeah, he fucked up. So he called him out, and then he made the security go grab him and bring him back.
Okay.
So he got back in the show, but I was just like, it was cool.
Yeah. That's hilarious, dude. Cool.
Like, that shit will never happen again kind of thing, you know? And it was on my birthday. I was like, fuck,
and it's the GOAT.
Yeah.
Like up for grabs.
And he sounded bad. Like, I didn't know he sounded like cigarette voice.
Oh, you
know?
So that's new Chappelle to you.
I was like, well, at that time, I'm 19. You don't. There really wasn't any Dave Chappelle shit for a long time. There's only the Chappelle show.
Yeah, there was so...
You didn't know what he sounded like. There wasn't like HBO specials or something.
You're right. There like really wasn't from Chappelle show on. There wasn't any like...
It kind of like took a break.
Like, stand-up he had.
He was like the guy, you know? I mean, I don't know. Don't ask me. I don't know everything.
To
but,
be
like,
honest, I didn't watch the Chappelle show growing up. Excuse me. I wasn't a Chappelle guy till like... I started getting like really into stand up. I'm a piece of shit. Yeah, like I definitely was like
I didn't even realize like, that was stand up kind
of
stuff.
It was literally like half of the words that come out of my mouth.
I know, and I realized how like prevalent it is in all of my friends' lives, and I was like, I've been fucking up. Yeah. Like I wasn't a Chappelle guy, and I don't know why. I was just like, you know, I guess I never watched
the
show.
He's arguably the funniest person. Like, he's fucking hilarious, man. Like, he's so genuine and, like, he's kind of out of his prime now. Dude, fuck you, Garrett. Genuine as in he's authentic, I guess is a better word.
Yeah, he's sincere.
His own way of comedy.
Yeah.
And then I also live with two douchebag haters. Talk shit.
Anyways, so, yeah. So, until it was announced that he was going to have specials on Netflix, like three or four specials, and this was like 2015 when this was announced or some shit. Mm-hmm. I was like, I'm not really like, I don't know much about Chappelle. Like, I know, but I would remind you, I had already started listening to podcasts, and the only podcasts I really listen to are comics. So they're all like, they all talk about Chappelle with such reverence. They're like, oh, he's the
GOAT.
Like the GOATs are like Burr, Chappelle, Rock. And Louis, those are like.
What happened to Eddie Murphy? Nobody likes him anymore.
Oh, he doesn't do stand up. He retired from stand up after the 80s.
Yeah.
Like,
but
he's
what's
still
like the
like,
all time guys then? Like, what would be like an all time five lineup?
All time
of now.
In my opinion, okay, someone was definitely just shot outside, and I've been seeing this helicopter circle the fucking
apartment. That happens
apartment.
A lot here.
Yeah. I'm just saying, no one's talking about it. Like, I don't live here. Like,
we've heard like. Yeah, over 10 shots in
it's
one
really
day.
It's bad. Really desensitized.
No, I moved to here from like a really ghetto neighborhood and watched shit happen and like no, you know what I mean? Like I'm not uninitiated.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, so the top five lineup, in my opinion, I don't know, like all time, like comedy, like it would, like the five best.
Yeah.
It's,
you don't even have to be in order, because then like
and I don't pick favorites. I think like the greatest comics ever have been Richard Pryor, George Carlin, Eddie Murphy, Chris Rock, Dave Chappelle. Is that five?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if you're bald. And if you're bald and or black, like no one's
gonna
like,
work out.
Yeah, if you can't make black people laugh, you're never gonna be a comic.
Oh, for
like
sure.
They're the gold standard. Yeah. I had this conversation. I had this conversation with my friend Honeycutt on the podcast once, and he thought I was like, if you can't make black people laugh, like. Well, what you must really suck because anyone can make him laugh. He thought I was saying that.
Oh, okay.
And I just needed to correct this because I don't know if I ever corrected that in that podcast or not. Like,
I feel like it's the opposite of that.
Exactly.
Almost.
Like, you, yeah. Like,
they pretty much, they're like the, if you can make them laugh, you know, it's kind of like some good shit.
That's like, that's the barometer of like, there you go. And I take that from so many comics saying, testifying like, oh, like, you don't eat shit until you go into a black room and your shit doesn't work there because this comedy club that like, they don't have time for your shit, you know? Because a lot of times they'd work in like an urban club and these would be working class people. And they're like, this is our night out. You can't waste it with your dumb, like, well, I was in Whole Foods the other day, you know, like you better make them laugh.
Yeah.
No, and sure. I hate to generalize.
Fake, you know, it's not, they're really about like respect and not being fake. And like, they know fucking, they can say how it is because they're
say how it is?
They can fucking say whatever the fuck they want. They're in positions to do that.
I'm sweating over here and I don't know if it's because we're, just stop guys. Yeah. There's our producer saying stop talking right now over there.
You guys want to frame me as a racist and you got it all fucked up.
No, but yeah. So like top five, like it has to be, it's like Carlin, Pryor, Chappelle, Murphy, Rock.
Dude.
Missing something in there.
Eddie Murphy and fucking Dave Chappelle like are easily the two funniest guys in my like opinion. Like those guys, I could watch their acts. Like I don't really know too much stand up. But like when I grew up, those were like the ones on Comedy Central over and over.
Yeah.
You know, like they were HBO specials and then they turned into free ones that were like reruns for years.
Yeah.
Like those were the best ones in my eyes.
Chris Rock was a big part of my childhood. Like one of the first stand ups I ever would like. We'd like rent like his Bigger and Blacker and Uncut, like all these like specials. And I think it was Rock. He had a special where he filmed four different shows across like the world or like in different nights, and the setup would start in one like place and the like middle of the joke and the punchline would be in different places. And I was like, wait, you mean like he just tells the same jokes everywhere? And I didn't dawn on me that like comedians like had to tell jokes over and over again and that was their act.
Yeah.
And I was like, wait, he is just doing the same. And that it was a really like big point where I was like, oh, like comedy isn't just being funny.
What do you think? What do you feel about that? Because I almost feel like it's like not, it almost takes out like the funniness of a person.
Well,
you know, when you're like expected to set a bar and then it stays there.
Not at all. Because the people who do it well do it so fucking like here, in my opinion, like who I think the greatest comedians are of today is Stanhope, Chappelle, Burr, Louis, and I don't know, someone fucking else in there. Those are like my guys. I think those are like the unfuckwithables. You go see Doug Stanhope, it sounds like he just came up with everything right there on the spot because he has everything so fucking well dialed in, everything to like his pauses and his like stammers and like it's so perfected and he knows that's his style of comedy. And even to like Chappelle will stop and like, you know, like philosophize and like, you know, take a drag off his fucking cigarette and like
he engages. Like when you engage more, the audience likes it. and it like gives you a break in a sense. You also get to, that is your sense of freestyle, you know, like he made a joke out of me that went on for fucking 10 minutes and like everybody on Maui talked about Will Hunt getting kicked out.
And no one, and like that's because so cool. He like arrived there. Yeah. Rock could make that special that has those different areas of the joke filmed in different places and shown different places in a special because he became so good and he is so good that it didn't matter.
And it's fluid.
It's so fluid. Yeah.
It's kind of weird like how you can see somebody wear like 30 outfits and like it goes like together like they're talking in the same sentence, you know? Like that.
Because they know their act front to back. You spend a year, 2 years.
They're also amazing talkers.
They're amazing talkers. You have to be good at that, you know?
I don't even think I'm the best talker. Like that's not, I don't feel like a strong, like I couldn't go on stage and
I'll admit like doing the podcast and starting this has made me realize like how bad I am at talking and how
I wouldn't say you're bad. I think
when I started, it was a real problem and I was like, this is hard. My throat hurts. I'm tired. I can't think straight. My balls are sticking to my leg. Like this is hard. I don't get, and then it puts into perspective of like, oh, these guys can really fucking do it. Anthony Jeselnik, unfucking like untouchable delivery, deadpan, dark humor. He writes it out. And then you watch that guy. You hate him?
Fuck that dude.
Both of you. You guys don't like Jeselnik? Oh my god.
I don't know who he is.
Yeah, dude.
Fuck, this isn't your fucking podcast. Shut up. Anyways, so yeah, this rich comedian that is better than these two scumbags on the couches next to me.
I know it.
Do you guys know who Anthony Jeselnik? Are we talking about the same guy?
Yeah, dude.
Yes, absolutely, dude.
Anyways, you two are pieces of shit. So anyways, let me finish my fucking thought.
Let Dallas finish. I don't even know who this fucking guy is. I want to hear his point.
Sorry.
I've never felt like me and my friends are political rivals more in my life. I don't know if I've ever disagreed with a subject with a friend in my life. Don't touch me, you cunt.
It will happen.
What I'm saying is I couldn't do what he does. I can't do what those people do. Like Burr doesn't write his jokes down. He doesn't fucking write them down. I had to write down talking to my friend I've known since second grade. It's right here on the note page next to me. I don't know how they do that shit.
Yeah.
So when I say like, it did kind of like steal some of the magic of like, oh, like jokes, they have to write these things down. They have to memorize them. They have to be funny a second time. You know when someone retells a joke and you're like, they kind of like, you messed up like the important part or you missed like the good part of the joke.
That's what I feel like I would overstress if I had all these like jokes written down. Like I wouldn't even be like, fuck.
But you learn. Listen, you do stress and there's nothing worse than when you're up there and you're like, you begin to doubt the joke you've written and you're telling it and you're like, I've been in the middle of a little 5 minute set. Like I'm no comedian, you know, I'm just an open micer to my traditional standards.
I wanted to ask you, how did your stand up go, by the way?
Oh,
how did that feel?
I would love to talk about that.
Yeah.
Right now. Perfect time. But like I've had like notes written down for like jokes because obviously I'm so new to it. I don't remember it. I don't know how to remember stuff then go tell people immediately when there's like 30 eyes looking at you because there's 15 people.
I mean, does like Joe Rogan like have like a 50-point thing that he memorizes before he goes on set or does he just
You do it in increments. So okay. You go to clubs, you get what are called spots where you do 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. You have...
So you take breaks in between your talking points or something?
No. So there'd be a lineup. Like you go to a venue and you see like bands, but there's comedians. Like me and Kylie would always go to the Comedy Store and we'd see 10 comedians. They'd each do 10 minutes each, 15 minutes each.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's how they do stand-up is they go work out at clubs.
Okay.
Because
so a long, like, 2 hour special isn't necessarily normal.
2 hours is insanely
okay,
long.
Okay, I don't even know.
Like an hour. The hour thing. Is a special, yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
The fact that you're saying HBO special is hilarious, too.
I don't even know what to put it. I'm just trying to make up a term.
Because, like, when we were kids, like, HBO was, like, right? It was, well, when I was a kid, it was Comedy Central. But when our parents were younger, it was HBO special.
That's what I mean. So
HBO,
I'm
Comedy Central special.
Stuff.
You know what's funny? Now it's the Netflix special. Because that's, like, the big one where everyone has their, like.
I know. It's crazy how it shifts. Then people are trying to change it to whatever they are. Netflix has pretty much got it on lock, though.
Yeah, no, they got it figured out. And I like
they screwed everybody.
But yeah, so like someone, I listen to a lot of Rogan. He talks about writing. Like he'll write stuff and extract jokes out of just writing.
Sure.
You know, he'll sit there and type. And like he records something that's really cool is he records his set on a phone, like up when he's up on stage for 10 minutes so he can listen back to it, listen to, you know, what part sucked, what part he needs to take out, or he thinks, oh, I missed the punt, you know, the setup for that one. And I've been on stage where I've like looked at my notes and I doubted the joke and I just didn't say it. And my set went like horribly horrible because I had no confidence in like my own thoughts. And people immediately are like, this guy is new to this. This guy is not good at this. He's clearly having some so like when there's a group of people watching you, it's like a mob. It can either be like a congregation or a mob. They can either be with you and they can be listening to the preacher and agreeing with them.
People, like, I mean, I'm sure that those clubs are kind of open to people trying it.
Unless if you go to a comedy club, there's gonna be open mic night. There's gonna be people that are gonna be laughing just at you trying too.
Yeah.
So that's different. Like. I was very fortunate to have someone that I knew in Lompoc who would just make a show because he played music and he'd be like, oh, and also Dallas was doing comedy. So it would be like, oh, cool, go see Dallas Bronson. He's going to tell dick jokes for 10 minutes or something.
So it's a little bit different than going to like that 15 minute kind of deal you're talking
about. Yeah, or like, and see, 15 minutes is a really long time for a new comedian. An open micer is going to get 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, and you're going to put your name on a list and they're going to go, okay, call you up.
How do they choose you to do the 15 minute kind of deal?
Just come in and you do enough people, like,
reputation?
Or you do enough sets and like people are like, hey, you know what? This Dane guy is here. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday is always here for open mic nights, and he's funny. Why don't we throw him on the 8 o'clock show in the main room or in the original room? Maybe he'll do something.
Do you make more money, or is it a free thing?
I think you get paid for your spots. They'll give you like $25 or something, like $20 in like the comedy store. I'm just talking about like comedy store, but
yeah, no, that's what I mean. I'm kind of using that as a baseline. Mm-hmm.
So it's funny because like
my next question would be more like, when do you start making money? Like, would it be more of like people are trying to go off of like podcasts and videos, or are they trying to get into clubs and work their way up in there to get their, I don't even know, their $500 check every Friday?
You know? Well,
like, how do you even make it in that?
So
it's like such a weird, it's almost like skating where it's like, it's a crapshoot almost.
Yeah.
You know?
Like, it's like most people are not going to be Nijah Houston.
Like, how the fuck did Chappelle make it?
He started when he was 14. That's how.
No, but still. But, like, where? Where did he go and, like...
There was a club, and they, like, were like, you sign up, and here, this kid, Dave Chappelle's going to do comedy. And, like, you know, said his name wrong. He walked up there, and he, you know, made some jokes. And it was, it was a bar, so, like, he had to have his mom with him, you know? It's just like that. Like, the bar in Lompoc before I moved... one of my friends did a singer-songwriter night there, and he's like, oh, would you want to do like comedy, like just do, you know, like a few minutes before we all go up one day. And I was like, oh, like, yeah, of course, like a new place to do comedy, a new audience, new crowd, more people liking my dick and shit, cunt jokes, like, fuck yeah, you know what I mean? I never got to do it because COVID happened, but it was just,
it'll happen.
Yeah, just you have
time
to
and a place.
You don't just like do, it's just like skateboarding, like you don't just do
it's
it.
There's not a formula.
There's
a semi-formula.
Yeah, there's a semi-formula. Yeah. Like, everyone knows, like, oh, you get better, you film a trick, you send a sponsor me tape. Like, oh, you go to open mic nights, you get better, you build your 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
There's a lot of gray area.
A lot of gray area. Also, you're asking someone who also is, like, by everyone's standard, like, I'm not a comic yet. You know, I am a beginner skateboarder. I'm a fucking... a white belt. You know what I mean? Like, I'm an open micer. Like, it's such a fucking...
Yeah.
What the fuck are you guys saying, you pieces of shit?
You said you're bisexual.
All right. Anyways, this isn't supposed to be about me. It's supposed to be about you.
Okay.
You're my guest.
I like talking about other people too, though.
Okay, that's part of what's cool about Dane. Anyways. Yeah. No, I just mean like.
What do you want to ask me?
What do I want to ask you?
Yeah. What else do you want to know about me?
God, you're really boring. I don't know. I'm just kidding.
I could just go off on stupid shit.
I love you when I, like, honestly, that is like part of, it's just a conversation to have. Like, I'm not really not trying to interview necessarily, but, like I asked you about, hey, like when'd you move to Hawaii? And that brought us here.
Yeah.
Like that was like forever ago.
And I'm going back.
When are you moving back?
No. I'm going to go visit, the 23rd till December 23rd till January 7th, I think.
Wow.
Yeah, got
it's a nice little spell there.
Yeah.
Dude, my last
There's
New Year's
some,
sucked.
New skate parks.
Fuck
Pukalani.
Yeah. Pukalani? That's a real word?
Something cool about Pukalani, so.
The spelling of that word?
Yeah. Oh, there's a couple cool things. You know what Pukalani means? Of course you don't. But
pussy liquor? Pukalani better mean pussy liquor.
It's pretty close.
Oh, what is it?
It's hole in the sky.
Hole in the sky? Hole like the sky. Sabbath song? About the hole in the ozone layer? That's badass.
No, it's... Okay, so it's kind of weird, but, like, in Pukalani, there's, for some reason, a lot of clouds and then a giant hole where, like, the sun comes through.
Yeah.
And that's why it was called Pukalani.
That's beautiful.
But...
See...
And another reason why I brought that up is, so I have a friend, Michael Seifer. When I moved out to Hawaii, like, he moved out around the same time, and we just, like... We were fucking boys.
Yeah.
You know, we'd smoke fucking fat bowls before going to high school and like the same music, skated and shit. But anyways, we had to do a senior project and Michael decided to do like a paper like, this is why we need a skate park upcountry.
Oh, that's cool.
And it got some recognition actually. Yeah. It got in the newspaper. And so they started a skate park. They built it now.
No fucking way. After all that time, they were like, hey.
After his senior project.
Dude.
And his name's nowhere to be found.
Ouch. Cypher had nothing to do with this.
Yeah. But yeah, he got it started.
That's fucking awesome.
Yeah, I haven't skated it. And fucking Nora's out there.
Vasculianos or whatever her name is.
Yeah, she's dating Albie Lair.
Try not to be dismissive of her last name. I just don't know it.
Nobody even says it.
Nora. Really?
Yeah.
The purple girl? Yeah. The lavender girl?
She rips.
Does she?
She
I don't
does.
I don't really know. I don't watch new skateboarders whatsoever. It took me a lot to watch because the last skateboarder I cared about last time, like they're gone. 2010 was the last time I cared about skateboarding.
What do you look for in a skateboarder?
Someone who was around when I grew up is someone who doesn't look like they just dress
You're
like
stuck
every
in the past,
fucking
dog.
Way. With skate, I can be with skateboarding. It's so fine with me. It's so
it's okay.
Easy.
It was more grungy. We were stuck in a
you know
super
what? Dude,
cool
you know
time.
Why? You know what? You know? When we were kids, it wasn't being talked about being put in the fucking Olympics.
No.
It wasn't like completely fucking raped
and it
by
just got
Nike
hype.
And Adidas. And all. You think about how many board brands, like people like that are just gone.
Mm-hmm.
Like shoe companies gone. There's pro skateboarders that we'll just never hear from again. Yeah. And I know this cycle happens to everyone. It happened to people in the 80s and 90s, early 2000s, mid 2000s, late 2000s, and now into the 2010s. I'm sure it's happening to people. Dude, it's even happening now. Like 2010s, like I'm like literally like, where are my favorite skateboarders? Like they're gone.
Yeah.
Like it hurt.
To
like
add to that, like I feel like those guys deserve so much more because what they've done to like our lives.
Because
like those
they've
people,
literally given so,
the money
so
that they
inspiring
have not made and the impact they've done to skateboarding, you know? Like, how much money is in skating and where it's being put is ridiculous, you know?
They're moral millionaires to me. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, dude. Like
I thought for sure, like, oh, like, these guys have to be loaded
like
because
anybody.
Who
you
would...
You can name any fucking person and they're average people.
Colt
you know?
Cannon.
Oh, he's like below average.
Ouch. I love Cole. Anyways, I'm just saying.
What are you talking about? Tampa M.
No, I'm saying as financial.
Andrew
Cannon's
great. But yeah, Andrew Cannon even, you know?
He's doing pretty good. Just because he's hooked up with Santa Cruz.
All right. Good for him.
Yeah.
But still, just...
But that's the thing is, that's the also, gray area. Also, luck. You know what sucked? Get in there.
Working at a skate shop, building skateboards at a skateboard factory, seeing like the shitty end, seeing like the gross, like seedy side of it of like, you guys are not like, watching a pro skater come in like, oh my God, you guys are making my board.
Oh, and you it's sell like, my board?
It was just like... Yeah, shut I make fuck your fucking up. Skateboard. I've literally been liking skateboards longer than you've been skateboarding.
Who was that for again?
Powell.
Peralta. Okay. So whose boards like, are you printing? Like what kind
whoever
of
whoever the fuck is on Powell?
Yeah.
They're who cares? Yeah, just shit. Well, I don't know. I never met Andy, and I hear he's cool, and he's always in Lompoc, and I think he literally lives in Lompoc and just kicks it with people. It's weird. But still, just I don't know. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, no, I mean, like...
Brent Ashley? Yeah, Brent Ashley.
Like, why is he not, like...
Where's Tosh Towen?
I don't know, but you know, all of them like, should be in a fucking country club together.
Exactly, there should be a skateboarding country for them. Club. Yeah.
You know, like, they should be able to retire and, like, go to, like, physical therapy or, like... They should be treated
where's
like
gladiators.
Dude, they were gladiators their whole lives. Like, they've been throwing their body on concrete.
Yeah.
And the least we can do is give them a little money to take care of their fucking bodies.
Ben Gilly shouldn't have to lift a finger.
Ben Gilly!
Yeah.
See?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like,
Ben Gilly.
You know what I mean?
It's sad.
There's a lighter right in front of you, stone piece of shit. There's two. There's three.
Just give me a lighter.
One, two, three. Grab one, you dumb bastard.
These ones are both.
You threw that one at me. You shouldn't get to use it. I fucking hate your dumb lighter. I'm glad I don't live here. That's a lie. I love you guys. I just mean like, I feel like I'd get so much meaner than I actually am.
Yeah. I was a dick for a while.
You were a dick for a while?
Yeah, dude. I was fucking angry.
Yeah, we know. Dude.
What happens, though, when you're stuck inside for a year?
Oh, yeah, because your knee.
Yeah.
You get a little bitter. I know, yeah.
That's so bitter.
Seriously, getting to go out... My voice is going from this shit. Getting to go outside and skate with you and, like, see you rip and, like, not land a Smith grind for 2 hours is awesome.
Dude, that fucking broke my heart. I don't know how I didn't fucking get that shit.
I don't know either.
It was so close.
I'm not trying to hurt your feelings,
yeah,
but...
No, I was like, all I need is like a hair.
It didn't
more
make,
of
it
something.
Didn't make
like,
sense
I was like,
to
I'm,
it didn't make sense that you weren't
I'm holding my breath.
I know you can. You got robbed from a couple.
Yeah.
I think what happens is I think you got robbed and then you got discouraged because it was that close. And then the next one wasn't as close because you got in your head about it maybe. You think?
Well, because the Smith is one of those tricks that when I was younger, I had it on lock.
Yeah.
And then I met Daniel.
And he
started
had
doing Smiths way better.
Oh. No.
And I stopped doing them because I ate shit a whole bunch
that
on
that happened to me with tray flips. He has a good tray flip.
Yeah.
I don't know anyone else that we skate. I always thought tray flips was like something I could keep in my back pocket.
I never
I
learned
a
nollie flip because I hung out with this kid, Miles Lorien, in Maui, who just like... It's just like, why would I even try nollie flip tricks when I'm doing them 2 inches off the fucking ground? And he's going like a foot and a half, just boned, like, bink. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? You're a pro. You are a fucking pro. Like, all right, I'll do a nollie big spin.
Dude, all Dane's friends from Maui are so fucking good at skating.
Yeah.
They're all so
All my boys rip. All my boys
shred.
Rip.
If you hang out with Dane, then you shred. That's pretty much
Yeah, dude, I don't it, fucking
unless,
hang,
unless
I don't
it's
hang out with
me,
people that
apparently.
Don't shred or at least have some fucking heart when they
oh,
skate.
Oh, that was me. He was talking to me when he said that. That was beautiful.
No.
He was
he just
looked
wants
at me
to call him fat. Dallas
oh,
just wants me to call him
you,
fat.
You son of a bitch. It's done. It's over. This podcast is over. Say goodbye,
He's
Dane.
He's a physically fit grown man with a mustache.
He's talking about himself.
He doesn't like it when I call him big man. He does big man tricks.
We went and got sandwiches. at Board and Brew, and this fucker, super cool guy, he's like, oh, yeah, totally. Just, you know, press a button, insert chip, you know, you want a drink? Oh, yeah, sure thing, big guy. And, like,
He said, oh, that's why, dude. You. That's why.
So then, you.
You got the triple threat or some shit. Like, I said it, and then you brought it up, and then he said it again. It's over.
And then,
yeah.
He like handed me like the can of Coke, and I was like, he's like, yeah, I sure got it. You know, we'll have that right out for you. Big guy. He called me big guy twice. I'm not that big. How fucking small are you to be like referring
to? Hey, you're a small Asian guy, yeah, so you are big.
I mean, I
but you, big guy.
I guess that is a bad thing to say. I don't even realize, I guess.
What if,
what my compliments are. Listen,
I know this is going to be like a little bratty, but say you're as short as him, and I'm taking his order, and I say, sure thing, little guy. You know.
Thank you, little guy.
Yeah, here you go. Have a good day, little guy. We'll have it right out for you, little guy. It's like, you didn't have to say that.
Also,
you didn't fucking have to say that.
That's why I started calling people buddy.
Buddy's good.
That's even worse.
Buddy's kind of.
That's like degrading Armenian sounds.
Degrading Armenian sounds?
Yeah. Okay, buddy.
Oh, that's not how Armenian sound. Okay, goodbye, buddy. That's not how Armenian sound.
That's how they sound.
That's what I don't know.
You know what Armenians sound like right now?
Sure. You said it.
Quality control. Are you wearing slip-ons, you fucking pussy?
Yeah.
What brand of slip-ons do they? Are those women's shoes you're wearing? It's their women's shoes. Damn, dude.
It's like a size 20.
Etnies.
The Michelin brand.
Yeah. All right. Let's end this fucking podcast. Garrett, fuck you. Daniel, fuck you. And thank you, Dane. Let's do this again sometime. This is the Bad Etiquette Podcast. Where the fuck are you?